the ranking. So everything that they have to get to Oxford to continue their season is all directly in front of them. First pitch today is going to be coming up in about 8 minutes at 3 o'clock. Now, since we've seen and talked about the UAH Chargers here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone, UAH last weekend traveled to Georgia to take on West Georgia, taking 2 of 3, and where they were at one point in time the number 13 team in the Gulf South Conference, they moved up a spot after taking 2 of 3 to number 12. Shorter, on the other hand, had a much better weekend last weekend, which is saying a lot, but they swept Montevallo at home just 5 days ago. You can hear the breeze going, and that means we're also getting closer to first pitch as well. But when we come back, we'll have today's starting lineups and the keys to the game as we move closer to first pitch between UAH and Shorter. This is UAH Baseball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
I'm Abraham here from my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating. So you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Welcome back to the UAH Chargers baseball pregame show here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone 2, as you are listening on your app this Friday afternoon. I am Joe Hunk here in the Crestwood Medical Center and Sports Med Baseball Press Box at Charger Park. Game 1 of the 3-game series between the Chargers and Shorter Hawks is coming up in just a few minutes as your Chargers are getting ready to take the field. But first, let's talk about tonight's starting lineup. Starting with the Shorter Hawks, batting first, playing right field, is going to be Jacob Pager. Batting second and playing left is going to be Kobe Jones. DHing for Shorter will be Alex Brody. Behind him, batting cleanup is going to be Justin Barnes. Playing first base, Griffin Clark in the 5-hole. Playing third, Norman Leon is going to be your second baseman for Shorter. Batting sixth, Logan Stockton. Behind the dish today and batting seventh, and Thomas Schroeder, the fourth, is playing shortstop for Shorter as Cody Krause will be in center field for the Hawks. And on the mound for them today will be Cole McDonald. For your UAH Chargers, Caleb Mahand leading off, as always, in center field. Merrick Carter behind him at short. Carson Vialta in the 3-hole. Playing second today, Brock Butler back at the cleanup spot in DH, and J.C. Wilburn is in right field, and he's going to have a heck of a day batting fifth today. Will Knowles is going to be tested. We'll talk more about that as we continue here on the pregame show, as he's going to be behind the dish. Jackson Lindsay at batting seventh, and at first, Ramey Harrison, always at third base, and eighth, and Presley Walker, who's been hitting very well lately, is at 9, and your pitcher for your UAH Chargers is Will Tarpley. Now, keys to the game today. First and foremost, we talked about Will Knowles. I hinted at that just a few seconds ago. The first key for UAH is going to be keeping Shorter off the base pass. This team and the Shorter Hawks have stolen 109 bases so far this season, and that is 36 stolen bases more than the number 2 team in the Gulf South Conference. So keep them off the base pass. Hits, walks, whatever it is, that is going to be a major factor in this 3-game series. The other part of this is the fact that if UAH does give up a crooked number, they cannot give up the Shorter pitching staff and Shorter defense gives you numerous opportunities to get back into games, as Shorter's defense has already had 51 errors this season, which is the fifth most in Gulf South Conference play. You can hear it in our booth right now as the press box is sitting right above home plate, and you can continue to hear the wind blowing hard from left to right as we get closer and closer to first pitch here at Charger Park. Now, coming up next, it will be first pitch from UAH and Charger Park here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone. Stick with us. This is Charger Baseball on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Installation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back as we are moments away from first pitch here at Charger Park on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone, as well as UAH Chargers in their YouTube channel. But right now, let's send it down to the field for our national anthem on this gorgeous Friday afternoon. With that, we are ready for some UAH Charger baseball as the Chargers are on the field and ready to go as pitching tonight, or today, as this afternoon, for UAH will be the junior Will Tarpley, struggling a little bit this season. This is going to be his ninth start so far on the year, as he has a 5.86 ERA. Four-game losing streak right now for the transfer from Snead State. Now behind him, going left to right, you're going to have Presley Walker in left. Caleb Mahan in center, and right is going to be J.C. Wilburn, who is going to have a heck of the day the next nine innings as this wind is blowing extremely hard towards right center field. So everything that goes in the air is going to be extremely dangerous today in the infield. Ramey Harrison at third, shortstop Merrick Carter is at, and then second base is going to be Carson Vialta. And at first, Jackson Lindsey. Will Knowles behind the dish for the Chargers as he is going to need to make sure that arm is loose with as much as this shorter Hawks baseball team runs when they do get on the base pass. As Will Tarpley is finishing up his warm-up pitches, and he is looking to have an outing very similar to what he did against Montevallo towards the end of March, where even though he only gave up one earned run, he did take the L in that one after pitching seven strong innings. But we are ready to go, and Jacob Pazier steps in for the shorter Hawks as the first pitch from Tarpley is going to be taken for a ball outside. Oh, 1 to Pazier is going to be low and inside as Tarpley is behind in the count early in this one. This is something that also hurt him a few weeks ago when he was pitching here at Charger Park, as third pitch of the at-bat is his first strike of the game. And now Tarpley is trying to work back and even the count up at 2 apiece as the 2-1 is delivered. That's going to be a fly ball to right field. Jason Wilburn is going to not be able to get to it. That ball is going to hop to the wall, and Pazier is going to be going towards second base, and he is going to stop there as Wilburn's getting an opportunity to kind of see how this wind is going to be going and affecting the ball today. Line drives at the moment that may not look like they're going to travel very far is in fact doing that for this team and for what's going to happen in both UAH and Shorter whenever they are hitting the ball to right center field. Now, with Pazier at second base, this is where Will Knowles is going to have to pay attention, because on the season so far, Pazier is fifth in the Gulf South Conference with 16 stolen bases. First pitch from Tarpley to Kobe Jones is going to be a ball inside, as Jones is batting on the left side, open stance, as we have just started game one of this three-game series between the Chargers and Hawks. Second pitch from Tarpley to Jones is called a strike to even the count at 1 apiece. As Jones crouched down in his stance on the left side, third pitch from Tarpley, breaking ball for a called strike two to get ahead in the count against Jones. As the Marietta native awaits his 1-2 pitch, which is going to be a called ball on the outside corner to even the count at 2 apiece. Tarpley looks back at Page, and Pazier is going to go back to second on the pop-up that's going to be into J.C. Wilburn in right field. Pazier going to act like he's going to third, but he's going to stay at second base. A ball hit that softly is what it was between Vialta, Mahan, and Wilburn is going to be dangerous today, because it's going to float behind Wilburn whenever the ball is that high up in the air, the way that that ball was. And it's going to take him a second to make sure that he is underneath it and it doesn't get past him. That could result in a run, which would have happened if he would have missed that one. So in steps Alex Brody as Tarpley tosses back to second base to keep Pazier close. As Brody is stepping into the right-hand batter's box right now, already having 9 home runs on the season, which is 9th in the Gulf South Conference, as first pitch to him is going to be outside for a ball. One 0 pitch delivered to Brody is going to be taken for ball two. Alex Brody also has speed. He already has 3 triples in the season, as the first strike called on a swing and miss by Alex Brody. Tarpley has done this a few times where he's gotten into a jam, runners in scoring position, but he's been able to get out of it. Happened a couple of weeks ago against Lee. Definitely happened in that Montevallo game that we referenced just a little while ago as well. And now he's trying to do it again against Shorter, as Brody steps back in into the right-hand batter's box and Tarpley delivers foul ball back to the net. Count count sitting at 2-2 on Brody with one out so far here in the top of the first inning. Tarpley set at the belt. Outside for ball three. Now full count on Brody. So far, Tarpley trying to keep everything outside on Brody, which may not work very well, but the next pitch to Brody is called ball four, and Alex Brody has got himself on the base pass. The only good thing about that is the fact that there's somebody in front of him, so you don't have to worry about stolen bases at this point in time. But anything hit in the gap can score Brody from first base with the way that he is able to run the base pass. But that does now bring up the grad transfer, Justin Barnes. Tarpley's first pitch to him is going to be high for ball one. Barnes, so far on the season, one of the most patient hitters in the Gulf South Conference. He's already got 25 base on balls this season, which is in top five in the conference. Tarpley delivers a 1-0 now that's going to be high as well. So now he's behind in the count 2-0 as Merrick Carter calls timeout just to try to get Tarpley a little bit of a time to give himself just a little bit of a breather. As right now, nothing is on the board for Shorter, so it's not as bad of a situation as what it could be. Here in the first, UAH has a history of giving up runs in the first inning, which Tarpley is trying to make sure he does not do. In fact, he's at times has been your game three starter for UAH. But getting the start here in game one, Tarpley's back on the hill and ready. Going to be high for ball three. Now he's behind in the count 3-0. With Griffin Clark standing on deck for the Shorter Hawks. And one more pitch, he's coming to bat with the bases loaded. Tarpley low in the dirt, ball four, and the bases are now loaded for Griffin Clark. So the junior steps in the right-hand batter's box right now with one out and looking for a bunch of RBIs as he takes the first pitch for a strike on the outside corner. Swung and missed for strike two, and now Will Tarpley is ahead in the count. Ground ball gets him out of the inning. Strikeout gets your second out of the inning and an opportunity to try to get out of this bases loaded jam as the wind continues to have a heavy breeze to right field. Tarpley just throws a little soft toss back to Carson Villalta at second base just to reset his stance. Now he sits, gets his foot back on the rubber and is ready to deliver the 0-2. Ooh, close fastball on the outside corner. Not called a strike by home plate umpire Matthew Wallace. And Tarpley still ahead in the count, 1-2, but with one out here in the top of the first inning. Tarpley throws, and that is going to be swung on and missed by Griffin Clark. Knowles, ball in the dirt, makes a great stop and tags Griffin Clark out on the pitch. And now UAH is one out away from getting out of this bases loaded jam. Norman Leon, the Shorter center fielder, I should say, the Shorter second baseman, steps in and takes a called strike one in the first inning. Still have the bases loaded. Barnes, Brody, and Pager on the base pass as Tarpley's 1-1 or 1-0 pitch is going to be a called ball outside to even the count. Two outs. Tarpley could get out of this bases loaded jam. Now it's going to be a soft ground ball to third base that Ramey Harrison grabs and tags the bag. And Will Tarpley gets in a jam and gets out of a jam to end the top of the first. And we now head to the bottom. It's UAH's turn to get going as you are listening to Charger Baseball 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
I'm Abraham here from my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating. So you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does. And they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Cole McDaniels is on the hill for the Shorter Hawks. Extremely high ERA that could benefit the UAH Chargers on this Friday afternoon. 2-2 on the season. His last outing was last weekend against Montevallo. He did go 8 innings in that one, but gave up 6 runs. In fact, it has been almost a month since he has pitched and not given up 4-plus runs. And that was all the way back on March 9th in a loss to Auburn Montgomery, where he only pitched in 1 1/3 innings in that ball game. So today he gets to start on this beautiful Friday, extremely breezy, as you can hear it this afternoon through our microphones, as Caleb Mahan is going to be starting it off for the UAH Chargers. Merrick Carter is going to be behind him. And Carson Vialta, 1-2-3 for UAH to get this going in the bottom of the first inning, as the top of the first inning saw Will Tarpley get into a jam, but was able to get out of it with the bases loaded. And now UAH is going to try to capitalize as you try to get a lead in a series that UAH needs to win. And they need to continue to win almost every single, as a matter of fact, they have to win every single series from here on out to put themselves in a position to make it to Oxford for the Gulf South Conference Tournament. So in steps Mahan, 336 average so far on the season. He does have 6 doubles. Only 1 home run right now, but 20 RBIs. The big thing for Mahan is not striking out, because he has done that so far a lot this season. McDaniel, first pitch is swung on and missed by Mahan, and he is now behind in the count, 0-1. McDaniel, the lefty, delivers, swung on and missed for strike 2, and Mahan is quickly behind in the count to start the bottom of the first inning for UAH. Mahan, the righty, takes for ball 1. As UAH today in the gray pants with the blue piping down the side, rocking the black jerseys today. As McDaniel's 1-2 pitch is also a ball to even the count at 2 apiece. Shorter is rocking some all gray uniforms that are just extremely dark gray. Very similar to what you'll see from a Tennessee Vols team, as the 2-2 count is fouled off. And Mahan, foot still outside the box, as he now steps back into the right side. Count still even at 2 apiece. As he hits a line drive to right field, that's going to get down, as Mahan's got a base hit to start the bottom of the first inning for the UAH Chargers. Great job on taking the line drive and taking the pitch exactly where it was thrown. That was a fastball outside on Mahan. And he just went with it for the line drive to Jacob Pager and right. And now UAH has a runner on first base with nobody out in the first inning for Merrick Carter, who basically leads UAH in every single stat that you can lead in. If there's a stat for the Chargers, Carter is most likely leading it at the moment, as Carter's first pitch to him is going to be a called strike one, and he is quickly down 0-1 in the count. As the lefty is ready for the 0-1, hits a foul ball down the right field line, going to now quickly be down 0-2 in the count. As Carter coming into this, batting 431 on the season so far. He does have 12 doubles. He does have 6 home runs. With the way the wind's blowing today, he could get 7. As McDaniel's ready for the 0-2 pitch. And Carter, check swing, fouls it back into the net. And the count remains 0-2. Carter still leading the Gulf South Conference in hits with 49 as well. The doubles that he currently has in 12 is third in the Gulf South Conference. And he has an amazing OPS of 1190 as McDaniel ready to deliver the 0-2. Carter fouls that one back in over the net. It's going to be going into the parking lot. Still 0-2. Nobody out in the bottom of the first inning for your UAH Chargers. Mahan gets a small lead over at first base as Shorter is in at double play depth, trying to roll something if Carter hits it in the middle. Instead, he is going to take a breaking ball for called strike three. And that will be the first out of the inning for the UAH Chargers. But that does bring up the lefty, Carson Fialta, who steps into the left-hand batter's box, batting 362 on the year, 28 RBIs, does have a home run, and he can crush a ball in left field or in right field if given the opportunity. But breaking ball from McDaniel is going to be a called strike again. So far, McDaniel has started two of the three UAH Chargers off with a breaking ball after Mahan got to first base. As Mahan now gets his lead, McDaniel looks over at first and fires. Going to be a fastball low and outside to even the count at one apiece. Vialta in the left-hand batter's box, extremely close to home plate, which is probably the reason why he leads the country in getting hit by pitches. McDaniel fires back over to first base to get Mahan back. No tag even attempted on that one. As the count sits even at one apiece with one out in the bottom of the first inning for your UAH Chargers. Here's the 1-1 from McDaniel. Going to be low and outside for ball two. And Vialta now ahead in the count. As so far early in this one, McDaniel's showing a tendency to want to try to pitch away from every batter, which with a lefty is going to be good because any ball hit to left field is going to be going against the wind. Here comes 2-1. Mahan swings. Hit and run was on, but Vialta fouls backwards over the net. And Mahan's going to have to trot himself back to first base right now as Vialta now has a 2-2 count after the foul ball. McDaniel on the mound, foot on the rubber, is ready to fire the 2-2 pitch to Vialta. Vialta hits it down the left field line, is going to be curving and is going to go foul, which is going to keep the count at 2-2. He went with the pitch on that. Another ball is going to be on the outside corner as he went with it, fighting it off for the 2-2 count. What he's looking for at the moment, if he goes oppo, there the shortstop is way in, out of position because of the shift, but instead Vialta hits a line drive right to center field as Cody Kraus makes the catch, and that is two outs now for your UAH Chargers. The uniqueness about the different levels of baseball is that you also have to remind yourself of rules, as in the shift in college baseball still allows for the shortstop to go over and pass second base, where now in Major League Baseball, the shift cannot allow to have three defensive players in the infield on one side of the infield. So in that instance, you had the shortstop for Shorter, Thomas Schroeder, all the way at the second base position, and the second baseman was sitting in short right field. But it resulted in an out, and now Brock Butler sits in with two outs in the top of the first. Mahan steals. Ball is thrown into center field as Mahan gets up, looks into center, but remains at second base after the stolen base to get him in scoring position here in the bottom of the first inning. Now Brock Butler has an opportunity to get himself his 27th RBI in the season if he can put a hit into the outfield. The left fielder for Shorter is playing extremely deep for the way that this wind is currently blowing. So if Butler hits anything soft into left field, is going to fall for a hit. He fouls the 1-0 pitch backwards to the net. And now he's looking at a 1-1 count in the first with two outs in the inning. Butler stepping in the plate, batting .342 so far on the year. He does have five home runs. He has 26 RBIs on the year, and number 27 is sitting at second base if he can put something in the outfield. McDaniel looks back at Mahan at second and fires. Fly ball is going to float backwards and out of play, and is just going to count as an extra pitch for McDaniel, as there's already two strikes. Brock Butler so far on the season is, oddly enough, the righty is batting worse against lefties than what he is righties so far. Against righties, he's batting .347. Against lefties, though, only .316. So see if he can raise that on this next pitch. But instead, McDaniel fires back to second base, and that's going to be missed by Leon, where it allows Mahan to now get to third base on the missed ball, which is going to go down as an error for the second baseman. As I looked to my right, because I was trying to make sure, I was like, that seemed like an error, but I just always wanted to make sure. And now Butler has an RBI just 90 feet away if he can get a base hit on this 2-2 count. McDaniel fires, delivers, and Brock Butler misses and for a swinging strike three. So UAH gets a man to third, but is unable to get him across the plate as we now head into the top of the second inning as you listen to UAH Baseball 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida. From first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans, they have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Shorter will be sending Logan Stockton, Thomas Shorter the fourth, and Cody Kraus to the plate in this top of the second inning as Will Tarpley is out for his second inning of work after UAH got a man to third base in the bottom of the first inning but was unable to get him across. And in steps Logan Stockton, as Shorter had the bases loaded in the top of the first, but Will Tarpley was able to get out of it to keep the score at 0-0, and that is the score that we currently have here in the top of the second inning. But first pitch from Tarpley is going to be high and outside for a ball. Stockton sits back in the right-hand batter's box and fouls one behind our press box for swinging strike. So now he is even the count, back at one apiece. Tarpley's done this a few times. He's had a rough first inning. He's been able to get back into and get into a flow in the second, third, and fourth inning as the 1-1 pitch is going to be called a ball outside. And now he's sitting behind Stockton at and hitting at a 2-1 pitch is going to now be a 2-2 pitch, or I should say, because of the swinging strike. As the righty awaits the 2-2, is going to be called ball three. Stockton having to step in the batter's box quickly because Will Tarpley is working fast here in the top of the second inning. The full count pitch, and Stockton hits a high fly ball into left field as Presley Walker is back to the warning track, makes the catch, and it is safe to say that if that is this wind is not blowing the way that it is from left to right field, that would have been a home run for Logan Stockton. Instead, it is just a long fly ball that caught for an out by Presley Walker to be the first out of the inning here in the top of the second. This is where the wind is going to play into this ball game as Tarpley's first pitch to Schroeder is going to be a breaking ball called for strike one. As Schroeder takes the second pitch and fouls that one up, Knowles as well as Jackson Lindsay making their way to the netting on the first baseline, but the ball travels foul and out of play to put Schroeder behind in the count 0-2 to start this one. As the wind is picking up, it is going to be blowing like this all afternoon long. So fly balls like what was just hit to left field to Presley Walker are going to die as Tarpley's 0-2 pitch is going to be taken for a ball outside. And Schroeder trying to fight back in the count as he is down 1-2 with one out in the top of the second, as Tarpley's next pitch is going to be low for a ball, and he is now even the count. Schroeder on the season's batting .262. He only has one home run, 20 RBIs on the year, and he's standing in the right-hand batter's box right now with a 2-2 count in the top of the second. As he hits a ground ball to the left side, going to be foul. And as Tarpley stands on the hill from the windup, his pants and jersey are basically stuck to him because of how hard the wind is blowing. As Tarpley's 2-2 pitch is going to be fouled directly behind us to keep the count at 2 apiece. So uniquely, Will is changing from the windup to the stretch. And this pitch is going to be from the stretch. And he throws a sidearm from the left side, which is going to be a ball to now get the count full. Now Tarpley back in the windup. Full count's going to be a low, and Schroeder has worked his way back and gets on first base for the first Shorter run of the inning. Now Schroeder, just like a lot of the other Shorter Hog runners, has 10 plus stolen bases. In fact, so far on the year, he's 10 of 11 from the position that he is in now. It's standing at first base. So Will Knowles needs to be paying attention as Cody Krause steps into the left-hand batter's box. First pitch from Tarpley is going to be high and outside. One out here in the top of the second inning. As Tarpley fires, it's going to be swung on and missed by Krause for strike one. One runs across the board, one ball, one strike, one out, and Will Tarpley throws one baseball over to first base to keep Schroeder close. As Lefty is back on the hill from the stretch and ready to go as Schroeder takes a nice lead from first base. Schroeder stays. Krause looks to bunt, but instead takes for a ball, and it's now a 2-1 count. Schroeder, so far on the season, is third in the Gulf South Conference in sack bunts, but he swings on the 2-1 pitch, and now it is an even count at two apiece, so you would think that the sack bunt opportunity is officially gone for him. The 2-2, swung on and missed on the breaking ball, and Tarpley gets the second out of the inning. And now we are back at the top of the lineup with Jacob Pager. Pager in the first inning doubled to start the ball game. On a line drive to right field, they got past J.C. Wilburn in this breeze. As Tarpley looks over at Schroeder at first base. Tarpley throws back. Schroeder had a little bit of a twitch with the right shoulder, like he was thinking about going to second, but does get back in time. And now Tarpley is back on the rubber for the first pitch to Pager. As a balk is called on Tarpley, and that is going to move Schroeder to second base. As now Schroeder is 180 feet away from scoring the first run of this ball game, and we are looking at a 1-0 count to Pager. Pager's next pitch is going to be fouled backwards to even the count. One count on Pager as he hits a fly ball to right center field. J.C. Wilburn's coming over. Caleb Mahan is going over, but Wilburn's going to call Mahan off, make the catch, and that will be the third out of the inning. So Schroeder gets a man to second base, but does not get him home as UAH is coming to the plate when we come back on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit InsulateWithEagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
ALSR number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Nothing score in the bottom of the second inning as Cole McDaniel is wrapping up his warm-up pitches, and UAH will be sending 5-6-7 to the plate. J.C. Wilburn, Will Knowles, and Jackson Lindsay. Will Tarpley's gotten himself into a little bit of a jam. First inning was a lot worse than the second. First inning, the Shorter Hawks got the bases loaded, but Tarpley got out of that one. In the second inning, Shorter got a man on second base after Tarpley balked. But Shorter was unable to get him in that one. And now UAH has an opportunity to try to get the first runs on the board. Here in the first, or in the second inning for your UAH Chargers, as J.C. Wilburn, who made or caught the last out of the top of the second inning, steps in with that 303 batting average. He does have 3 home runs, 18 RBIs. And the first pitch from McDaniel is going to be outside for a ball. JC and the two wins against West Georgia last weekend as he swings and misses on a 1-0 pitch to even the count at one apiece. Had two hits in the first game of the doubleheader on Saturday as he fouled the 1-1 pitch backwards. But outside of that, that was kind of all that he really did in parts of this one. Did have an RBI in game one of the series against West Georgia. As now he is fighting as he's behind 1-2 and fouls it back to the brick wall as you heard that one bounce off and bounces all the way back to the pitcher as he tosses. Now what is a batting practice baseball over to the UAH dugout. And Wilburn is trying to keep this at bat going as he is behind in the count 1-2 from McDaniel. The 1-2 is going to be high for ball two, which evens the count for JC. As his average is hovering around 300, and now he takes ball three in the count, and the count is full for the Lawson State transfer. McDaniel pitching from the stretch. And Wilburn hits a pop fly into the right field Bermuda Triangle. The right fielder, Jacob Pager, puts his glove up and makes the catch. And that becomes the first out of the inning for the Shorter Hawks as UAH still looking to get a solid hit in this one, which would be the first since Caleb Mahan's first hit to start the ball game. So Will Knowles is going to step into the left-hand batter's box as he has been hitting tremendously from the left side so far this season, batting 338. And breaking ball almost hits him in the left-hand batter's box, but he takes it for a ball. And he is now quickly ahead in the count 1-0 with one out in the top or the bottom of the second inning. Second pitch from McDaniel is going to be a called strike on the outside corner to even the count at one apiece. As McDaniel works quickly, and Knowles hits a line drive over shortstop Thomas Schroeder's head. It's going to go into left center field. Knowles is rounding first base, heading to second as the throw comes in. And that will be Will Knowles' second double of the year in the top or the bottom of the second inning. So now UAH has a runner in scoring position with an opportunity to take the lead early in this ball game, which is an extremely important baseball game for your UAH Chargers as they are trying to get at least into the eight spot to get to the Gulf South Conference tournament coming up in a few weeks in Oxford, as they have 9 conference games remaining over the course of the next 3 weekends, with this one being the first of the 9. McDaniel looks at Knowles back at second base and fires to Jackson Lindsey. It's going to be taken, breaking ball again for a first pitch ball, as McDaniel so far is continuing to start the lefties off with a breaking ball on the first pitch. Now McDaniel set at the belt and fires. That's going to be a called strike. That's not going to be a called strike. Matthew Wallace was looking to get into a position to call a strike, but instead let it go. And now Jackson Lindsey is ahead in the count 2-0 with catcher Will Knowles standing at second base, which could represent the first run of the ball game. The 2-0 in the dirt, going to be stopped by Logan Stockton, and Will Knowles is going to remain at second base as now Jackson Lindsey is in a fantastic position looking at a 3-0 pitch coming up in just a few seconds. As the lefty steps back into the box and awaits the 3-0 from McDaniel. That's going to be taken for a called strike 1. And now Jackson Lindsey, who was taking all the way on that 3-0, still in a great opportunity as Thomas Schroeder is across second base, meaning that they are in a massive shift for Schroeder. So if Lindsey could even hit a dribbler to the shortstop position, it's going to be a base hit. Instead, he swings and misses on the 3-1 breaking ball for a called strike two. And now the count sits at it being full with one out in the bottom of the second inning. McDaniel at the belt, ready to fire. As Jackson Lindsey hits a ground ball to second base, which is picked up by Leon. Moves the runner over to third, but is still out at first for the second out of the inning. And now UAH does have an opportunity with a man at third base, but now Ramey Harrison steps in with two outs. Ramey Harrison steps in the left-hand batter's box and fouls one into the parking lot behind us here at Charger Park. 333 on the season so far. He only has one home run, but he does have 13 RBIs. As now he's behind in the count 1-0 and tried to stop his swing, but still committed. And it's now looking at an 0-2 count with two outs in the bottom of the second inning with Will Knowles standing at third base 90 feet away from the first run of the game. McDaniel's 0-2 pitch is swung on and missed by Ramey Harrison. So UAH gets another runner to third, but is unable to get them across as we remain tied as we now head in to the top of the third inning. You are listening to UAH Baseball 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
UAH has gotten some runners to third base, but they've been unable to get the key hit to move him in to put the first runs on the board. And now we are heading into the third inning with a tie ball game at nothing apiece at Charger Park on this beautiful Friday afternoon. Wind blowing extremely hard from left to right. So far, that's only played a factor in maybe one hit so far in the ball game, which was the first hit of the ball game for Schroeder to start the game off as Pager hit a line drive to right field. Other than that, the wind has not really been a factor, even though it is blowing extremely hard. As the left-hand batter, Kobe Jones, steps in for the Schroeder Hawks to start the top of the third inning and hits a hard ground ball to first base. Jackson Lindsey dives and makes the catch, but the ball is going to be foul, and that is just going to be a strike. Kobe Jones, so far in the season, at the moment, I should say, he is batting .380 on the year, but he's coming into this ballgame with a 7-game hitting streak, and in fact, he also has a 4-game RBI streak that he has so far after getting RBIs against both all three games against Montevallo and Morehouse earlier in this week in the win by Schroeder, as Schroeder currently has a 5-game winning streak as they're taking on the Chargers tonight. The 0-1 was a ball. Here comes the 1-1 pitch from Will Tarpley, which is also going to be a ball. So Kobe Jones, after fouling the first pitch off, is now ahead in the count 2-1. As he hits a fly ball, it's going to be foul, but Ramey Harrison is over in foul territory to make the catch for the first out of the inning. Soft fly ball
Wind was able to help it stay in the ballpark just enough for Ramey Harrison to get underneath it. And that accounts for the first out of the inning. As Alex Brody steps in after walking in his first at bat. Brody takes the first pitch for a called ball. And so far on this year, Brody has been tremendous as he takes a called strike one to even the count at one apiece. So far, he has the number three OPS in the Gulf South Conference at 1.203. As the 1-1 pitch is going to be high for a ball. He is also currently sitting at second in the Gulf South Conference in triples as he takes the 2-1 for a called strike to even the count at two apiece. One out. Four shorter in the top of the first inning. Tarpley's 2-2 is going to be caught by diving Ramey Harrison at third, but he's unable to get up and make the throw. And that is going to go down as a hit for Alex Brody to get the shorter offense going here in the top of the third inning. Great defensive play. Just Ramey was unable to get it up, get the ball up and get the ball to first base for that out. So instead, the shorter Hawks now have a runner at first, and Justin Barnes is stepping in. As the grad transfer so far this year, very patient at the plate. We talked about it his first at bat, which he takes the first pitch for a ball from Tarpley. Second pitch is going to be hit to center field as Mahan is traveling back into the gap. He's going to get underneath it and make the catch. Brody is heading to second base after UAH gets a little bit sleepy, but still makes the out at second base. As Brody thought that he was going to catch UAH napping, but instead, Mahan was able to get the ball to Vialta. Vialta throws and gets it to Carter, and Brody is tagged out at second base for the third out of the inning. So Will Tarpley gets out of another one, doesn't even let a runner advance to second base in this one, and now we head to the bottom of the third inning. It is shorter 0, UAH 0, as you listen to Charger Baseball 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
So your classic 8-4-6 double play gets UAH out of the top of the third inning. After Caleb Mahan catches a fly ball, Alex Brody tagged up at first base after he thought UAH was napping. But instead, Vialta was able to get the relay throw to Carter for the third out of the inning. And now we still sit at a nothing-nothing score in the top of the third, which brings Presley Walker to the plate. And then we head back to the top of the lineup in Caleb Mahan. Also want to say a special thank you to 97.7 ESPN The Zone program director Steve Moulton, because he is taking care of me today, bringing me some Charger hot dogs from the concession stand as he is getting ready to call Charger softball over on our sister station's app, or I should say 97.7 app, as Presley Walker hits a fly ball to left field, which is going to be caught by Kobe Jones. for the first out of the inning. Kobe Jones did a great job on that ball, knowing about what the wind was currently doing, because he backed up enough to give the opportunity to run up on that baseball instead of potentially being a hit for Presley Walker. That was now just a long fly ball out, as Mahan steps in for his second plate appearance of the ball game. 1-for-1 on the day. Single to right field, arguably the hardest hit ball by UAH so far through the first two innings, as he takes a called first strike. Fouls the second pitch of the at-bat back, and now we're looking at an 0-2 count on Caleb Mahan. He did get behind in the count to start the first at-bat as well. Got behind 0-2, as a matter of fact, but was able to fight back and get a good pitch to hit to right field. Let's see if he can do the same, as he fouls the next pitch back as well, as that one's going to head over to the UAH Charger softball field. Mahan came into the game batting 336. Now with that hit he got just a few minutes ago, he's now raised that average to 342, as the 0-2 pitch is going to be swung on and missed by Mahan, and he strikes out, which is one thing he has done an awful lot so far this year, as that was his 35th strikeout of the season. But Merrick Carter steps up, who is Mr. Everything for the UAH Chargers, batting 427 on the year. He does have 6 home runs. He has 33 RBIs. And the lefty is trying to keep this inning going for the UAH Chargers, as the home plate umpire, Matthew Wallace, called time. And now everybody's kind of confused, as we're all looking over to the shorter dugout down the third baseline, trying to figure out what's going on. But instead, we are now good to go, and McDaniel steps back on the rubber and fires. As another breaking ball to start off a lefty is going to be called for a ball, and now Merrick Carter is ahead in the count 1-0. McDaniel ready with the 1-0. Off speed, going to be low and outside, and Carter's now sitting pretty with a 2-0 count, but does have 2 outs in the inning, so he's got to get on to keep this UAH third inning going. The 2-0 from McDaniel is going to be fired back, and you can hear it bounce off the concrete at Charger Park for now a 2-1 count on the foul. Carter in the left-hand batter's box awaits the 2-1 from McDaniel, as that's going to be a call to strike 2, and now the count is even with 2s across the board. So far on the season, Merrick Carter's batting 429 with the bases empty, as he fouls off the 2-2, and we'll do it all over again. He's had 63 different opportunities to come to the plate this year with nobody on base, and 27 of those times he has gotten a base hit. Let's see if it can be number 28, as McDaniel fires a 2-2, and Merrick Carter gets a base hit to right field. So now he's 28 of 64 with the bases empty, and he keeps this one alive for UAH. Vialta flew out to Cody Krause in center field in his first at bat, but the lefty is looking to keep this one going, as if he can get one in the air, it can go because of how hard this wind is blowing this Friday afternoon. McDaniel's first pitch is going to be swung on and hit to left field to Kobe Jones, who makes the catch, and that is the inning. So UAH gets a man on first, doesn't get anything going though, and now we head to the top of the fourth. That is still nothing at Charger Park. You are listening to UAH Baseball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation, it's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
ALSR number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Top four. As Will Tarpley finishes his warm-up tosses, still nothing-nothing as UAH in a must-win series against the Shorter Hawks, who Shorter coming into this ballgame on a five-game winning streak. Currently sitting in the eighth spot in the Gulf South Conference, which is the final spot for the Gulf South Conference tournament. UAH is sitting in 12. But three of those teams that are in front of them will be seen by the UAH Chargers over the course of the next 3 weeks. As the first pitch from Tarpley, it's going to be a hard ground ball to third base. Ramey Harrison makes that catch, and he fires over to first for the first out of the inning. And Griffin Clark's bad few weeks continuous. He came into this one with only having one game over the course of the last eight games to result in a game where he finishes with a hit, and instead he remains hitless on the day with this one. And the second baseman Norman Leon steps in after grounding out in his first at bat. First pitch from Tarpley is going to be a fastball in the dirt, and Leon is quickly ahead in the count 1-0 here with one out in the top of the fourth. The 1-0 from Tarpley is going to be called for ball two, and now Leon sitting in a nice position. As the 2-0 pitch comes, that's going to be a ground ball, hit to third base as Harrison grabs that one, throws that over to first, and quickly, we now have two outs in this inning as Tarpley doing what he does, which is having a rough first inning, kind of settling down in the second, and then kind of gets things going in the third inning on. So we'll see if his trend continues. As we now have two outs in the top of the fourth inning, and Logan Stockton coming up to bat, which his first at bat in the top of the second inning for him, had a hard fly ball hit the left field, but with the way the wind was blowing, Presley Walker was able to make the catch at the warning track. It would have been a home run except for the hard wind that's blowing from left to right. And now Stockton is in the right-hand batter's box as Tarpley has quickly fallen behind 2-0 to the Stockton. And Stockton now is looking at a 3-0 count. The grad transfer, or I should say the grad senior, takes for a four-pitch walk, and quickly Tarpley has gone from having two outs and nobody on to now having two outs and one runner on, and Hunter Royer is going to call timeout and head to the mound to talk to his starting pitcher. Now, when we've talked about how important this series is for UAH, if you're just joining us, whether it's on the 97.7 ESPN The Zone app and you're listening on Zone 2, or if you have just hopped in on the UAH YouTube channel, which you can watch all YouTube, all the games that UAH has, whether it's softball, lacrosse, baseball, all of that, you can all watch it on UAH's YouTube channel. So make sure that you subscribe there as well. And by doing so, you can get notifications whenever they go live and everything. But we talk about how important this series is because UAH at the moment is behind three other teams for the final spots in the Gulf South Conference tournament as Thomas Schroeder, the fourth, takes for a called strike one. The 0-1 from Tarpley is hit sharply down to the left field. Presley Walker is going to get it on the roll, and Stockton is going to stop at second base. So base hit for Schroeder to keep the inning alive. And now Schroeder has two men on and Cody Krause coming to bat. He has struck out once in this ballgame. His first at bat, swinging miss and swinging strikeout for him. But so far on the year, Krause is batting .296 coming into this one. He does have three home runs. And as Tarpley delivers, he falls on the mound. It's a called strike one. Fantastic diversion for Krause not to swing on. And everybody wants to make sure that Tarpley is okay. He says that he is. And he is now on the rubber and ready to fire the 0-1 pitch to Krause. 0-1 in the dirt. Nice stop by Will Knowles on that. Everybody stays in place. And now the count sits at even. Two outs in the inning. Tarpley quickly got the first two outs, but now he has runners on first and second. And he's throwing an even 1-1 pitch to Krause, as that's going to be called strike two. Which leaves Tarpley one pitch away from getting out of another jam with a runner in scoring position. Krause steps back into the left-hand batter's box, and Tarpley's ready. The 1-2 is going to be taken for a ball to even the count at two apiece, and we now have twos across the board. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, two men on for the Shorter Hawks. And the 2-2 pitch from Tarpley is going to be barely swung at, excuse me, swing, which fouls that back to the on-deck circle as Jacob Pager picks it up. And we'll do it all over again. 2-2 count as Tarpley sets and fires. Breaking ball just a bit low as it now has a full count. And with two outs, that means that the runners will be moving. Thomas Schroeder at first, Logan Stockton at second. Both will be moving on the full count pitch from Tarpley. Tarpley knows it and fires back towards Merrick Carter at second base. Stockton gets back with ease. As the wind continues to pick up, it's been extremely breezy so far all day long, especially in the first three innings of this ballgame. Tarpley is trying to get out of the top of the fourth, and he will as Krause swings and misses. Will Tarpley gets in a small jam, gets out of it, and now we head to the bottom of the fourth. Still nothing as you listen to UAH Baseball 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida. From first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans, they have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Will Tarpley continues to get out of jams as we are heading into the bottom of the fourth inning. Nothing score here at Charger Park between Shorter and your UAH Chargers. 4-5-6 going to be stepping in against Cole McDaniel on this Friday afternoon, and is going to begin with Brock Butler. As McDaniel is ready, as he is about to wrap up his warm-up pitches, which seems like they have taken forever, and I don't know why that is. But McDaniel has made his way to shorter from Butler. Yes, the Butler in Indianapolis that you have heard about, he makes his way there. The unique thing about McDaniel is that could benefit UAH as this game continues to go on. So far in the season, he is 7th in the Gulf South Conference in base on balls given up. He has given up the 6 most runs. He's given up the 6 most earned runs. And teams are batting .332 against him. So there are plenty of opportunities for UAH to get going, as the first pitch from McDaniel to Butler is going to be a ball outside. And Butler's a fantastic person to get this going. He has hit safely on 6 of his last 7 ball games. And in fact, he has about a 4, maybe 5 game streak of RBIs that he has gotten over the last 5 games. And after seeing his batting average drop to .333 a couple of weeks ago, he's now worked it back up to .342 as he swings and misses on that, evening the count at 1 apiece. McDaniel sets and fires, and now is behind in the count, and Butler's looking at a really good opportunity, being ahead in the count 2-1, with nobody out here in the top of, or the bottom of the fourth inning. McDaniel's 2-1 pitch is going to be fouled backwards to make that strike 2 on the Meridian transfer. Butler steps back into the right-hand batter's box, 2-2 count, swing and misses for a swing and miss for strike 3. So one out, 4 shorter in the top or the bottom of the fourth inning, and J.C. Wilburn now steps in. And as he steps in, Shorter's head coach kind of wants to look at McDaniel just to see if McDaniel's okay. The home plate umpire, Matthew Wallace, walks out to check on McDaniel as well. As I actually missed what happened to him on that exchange, and the reason why the training staff for Shorter, as well as the head coach and the home plate umpire, were all wanting to make sure McDaniel was okay. But he says yes, he's waved everybody off. And J.C. Wilburn steps into the right-hand batter's box as he is 0-for-1 on the day. And McDaniel's 0-0 pitch is going to be a called ball to start this at bat for Wilburn. Wilburn, who could be one of the most important players of the ball game for the UAH Chargers, playing right field again today, as the second breaking ball from McDaniel is going to be a called strike 1 on the outside corner. With the way this wind is blowing for Wilburn, him and Jacob Pager and Wright could have a busy day if these bats start going. But right now, there's only been 6 total hits through the top of the fourth inning. As the 2-1 pitch now comes to Wilburn, it's going to be outside. Now Wilburn's looking at a fantastic opportunity. 3-1, and McDaniel's continuing to work Wilburn to the outside. So with the way this wind's blowing, if Wilburn can just be patient, take one oppo, he can get an extra base hit. But instead, McDaniel throws a fastball inside to make the count full. Full count, 1 out, bottom of the fourth inning for your UAH Chargers. As McDaniel, full count pitch is fouled backwards into the net, and we're going to do that one all over again. As Wilburn is ready to go in the right-hand batter's box, and he is going to take ball 4. And UAH now has a runner at first base with 1 out in the bottom of the fourth inning. So in steps Will Knowles, who had a double in his very first at bat to left center field, and has raised his batting average to .347 on the year. As the catcher steps into the left-hand batter's box and hits a ground ball to shortstop, Schroeder grabs it, tags second base, throws over to first for the double play, and UAH is done in this inning. So we head to the top of the fifth. Still nothing here at Charger Park as you're listening to UAH Baseball on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Nothing ball game here at Charger Park on this beautiful Friday afternoon as you are getting very close to wrapping up your work week. We appreciate you listening on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone. And right now, Will Tarpley is pitching tremendously as he has let a couple of batters get into scoring position but has gotten out of it. And it's major when you're talking about a team for the Shorter Hawks, who are number four in the Gulf South Conference in RBIs and runs scored. And so far, they have a big zero on the board. So we're going to see if Will Tarpley can continue to do this in his fifth inning of work, as the Shorter now starts with the top of their lineup. Jacob Pager steps in to take a called first strike. Pager now with an 8-game hitting streak after doubling in the first inning. The 0-1 from Tarpley is going to be hit foul, but it's going to be in the Bermuda Triangle, which a diving Merrick Carter is unable to make the catch. And instead of that being an out, it's just a long strike. And now we're looking at an 0-2 count to the senior from Dunwoody, Georgia. Talking about how many runs that this Shorter team normally puts up, Pager actually is sixth in the GSC because he has 43 RBIs on the year from the leadoff position, as he hits a fly ball to left center field that looks like it is going to drop in between Presley Walker, Caleb Mahan, and Merrick Carter. And that soft line drive is going to result in a hit for Shorter with nobody out to start the fifth inning. And now this is where Will Knowles comes into it, because Jacob Pager on the season has 16 stolen bases. He's fifth in the conference of 16 of 18. So not only does he steal a lot of bases, he's smart with whenever he tries to take a bag, as he gets a small lead at first base for a called ball on the first pitch to Kobe Jones. Tarpley looks over to first, fires to Kobe Jones, who checks his swing but still goes too far, and home plate umpire Matthew Wallace calls it a strike to even the count at one apiece. UAH in double play depth in the infield, shaded to the right side in the outfield. Tarpley with a little check throw over to first base just to keep Pager a little closer, as Will Knowles understands about the speed that is sitting at first base, as a high fastball on the inside part of the plate's too high and it's going to be called for ball two. And Kobe Jones is now ahead in the count 2-1. Tarpley fires back to first base, quickly tries to pick off Pager, but is not going to be in time. And now he steps back on the rubber and is ready to throw the 2-1. Breaking ball, going to be a called strike two, as in the count is now even. Ground ball could result in two, which could help UAH out with the speed that they're looking for. Anything that's hitting the gaps actually could score Pager. Tarpley still working on Pager at first base as he throws over again to keep him close. As the senior dives back in, and Tarpley throws back over again. Him and Jackson Lindsay just playing a nice little game of catch that's just resulting in Jacob Pager to go back and forth between his lead and first base. I want to say that's the fourth time that Tarpley's thrown over in the at-bat, and now he throws home with a breaking ball in the dirt, stopped by Will Knowles, which now makes the count full to the senior from Marietta, Georgia. As Kobe Jones steps back into the left-hand batter's box and awaits the full count pitch from Will Tarpley. That's going to be in the dirt. That's going to be ball four, and that is the second runner of the inning, as Shorter now has runners on first and second. So Tarpley once again in a jam. He has the ability to pitch out of it. He's done it a lot so far this season. But now he faces Alex Brody, who is arguably the best hitter on the Shorter Hawks team. As the first pitch from Tarpley is going to be too low for ball one. Tarpley's 1-0 pitch is now going to be a called strike on the outside corner. As so far on the season, Will Tarpley, with runners in on the base pass, has given up a batting average of .348. And now he is ahead in this one, 1-2 to Alex Brody. So trying to get the strikeout. As he looks back to first base and Jacob Pager, but doesn't make the throw, and Jacob Pager wants to try to get a balk called on Tarpley, to no avail. As Alex Brody steps back into the right-hand batter's box, and the 1-2 count is about to be on its way with no outs. Swung on, missed, and there is your first out of the inning. A big strikeout for Will Tarpley to get the first out of the inning. And now that will bring up Justin Barnes, who so far on this game has walked. He's also flown out to center field, deep ball to Caleb Mahan, which, if you remember back a couple of innings ago, this was when Alex Brody was also on first base and tried to catch UAH napping and was then thrown out at second base for a double play. UAH gets a double play here. They get out of the inning. Tarpley tosses it back to second base. Vialta doesn't even attempt a tag on Jacob Pager. And now Tarpley gets ready to throw his first pitch to Justin Barnes, with Kobe Jones on first and Jacob Pager on second for the Shorter Hawks. As first pitch from Tarpley is going to be a called strike on the inside corner of the plate. Justin Barnes has an opportunity for some RBIs, but there's still nobody on or that has crossed the plate for either team, as we're still nothing in the top of the fifth. Fastball a little high for ball one to even the count at one apiece. And Tarpley trying to get out of yet another jam in this one. Throws a 1-1 ball in the dirt that is stopped by Will Knowles. As you hear that wind blowing up against our microphones here at Charger Park. 2-1, and they have an opportunity now to get Kobe Jones as he tripped and fell. Instead, they're going to throw across the base, and Jacob Pager attempts to get the third with the pickoff throw going to first, and instead, Jackson Lindsey throws to Harrison, who Harrison runs down Jacob Pager, and that is going to be your second out of the inning as Harrison tags Pager. Pager dropped to the ground, and Harrison tags him as he rolled over the runner at second for the second out of the inning. As if you are scoring this one at home, that will be a 1-3-5. As on the throw, Kobe Jones did make it to second base, but with that being said, we're looking at a 2-2 count to Justin Barnes with two outs in the top of the fifth, and a ground ball now hit up to shortstop. Merrick Carter gets to it, doesn't catch it, and that is going to result in his 16th error of the season. As Justin Barnes makes it to first and Kobe Jones moves over to third base on the error. So now Shorter has runners on the corners and Griffin the Clark is getting an at bat that he probably shouldn't have because of the error. But the first pitch from Tarpley is going to be low and inside, and now Tarpley is quickly behind 1-0 to Griffin Clark, who is 0-2 on the day. He struck out swinging. He is grounded out as well. But he does have an opportunity for an RBI with Kobe Jones sitting on third base with two outs here in the top of the fifth inning as the second pitch from Will Tarpley to Griffin Clark is going to be called a ball, and now Clark is ahead in the count 2-0. Tarpley is inching closer to the 100 pitch threshold as the 2-0 pitch is fouled back into the net for the first strike of the at bat. The 2-1. Going to be taken inside, and instead you're going to have a double steal. The first runner of the game is going to score, and as Carson Vialta was trying to throw back to first base to Jackson Lindsey, instead he hits Justin Barnes. The ball then rolls all the way into or close to the UAH dugout, and so now Shorter has the first run of the ball game, and Justin Barnes is standing on third base with two outs in the top of the fifth inning. A lot happened in that.
That throw down second's tough with this wind. That ball's gonna sail.
Tarpley with the 3-1. Going to be ball four and issues a walk. So now, Shorter, who was given a gift by Merrick Carter at shortstop position, has turned that into a run. They now have a runner at third base, and they have a runner at first base with two outs in the top of the fifth inning. Norman Leon steps in and takes a first pitch ball as he is grounded out twice so far in this one. As the 1-0 pitch is fouled softly back to the Shorter on deck circle to even the count at one apiece. Leon has grounded out twice so far in this one. Shorter has put one run across. And Tarpley is trying to hold it to just one as the breaking ball is called for a strike. And once again, Griffin Clark now slowly tries to steal second base. And instead of throwing it, Will Knowles holds on to it to keep Justin Barnes at third. So Griffin Clark steals second base on a no throw. And that now results in another ground ball to shortstop. Merrick Carter picks that up, throws it over to first for the third out in the inning. But due to the error, Shorter now leads 1-0 as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. You are listening to UAH Baseball on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
SportsVet is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at SportsMedAlabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
So after a busy top of the fifth inning, Shorter now has a 1-0 lead as we head into the bottom of the inning. And up first for the UAH Chargers is going to be Russellville native Jackson Lindsay, who had an amazing game against West Georgia last weekend in the series finale, as he had 2 home runs, 5 RBIs, 3 hits in that ball game. And he's now trying to get UAH on base here in just a few moments to try to get a run for the Chargers. Don't forget that coming up here in about 30 minutes over across the Charger Parkway from us will be UAH softball, as that is about to get going as well. This game between UAH and Shorter was originally scheduled for 4 o'clock, but got bumped up to 3 o'clock. And the UAH softball team is going to get going at 5 tonight. You'll be able to hear that over on our other Zone app, which will be Zone 3 as well. So don't forget, if you do not have that and you're listening to the UAH baseball game on the UAH YouTube channel, to download 97.7 ESPN, The Zone's app, because we have about 6 different ways for you to listen to sports that come from 97.7. As the first pitch to Lindsay is going to be a ball from McDaniel. Lindsay hits a soft fly ball into center field. It's going to drop in front of Krause, and that's going to result in the first runner of the inning for the UAH Chargers. Just a soft little dinker in the middle of center field, and now UAH has a runner on first base for Ramey Harrison, who has been tremendous at third base so far today. Now looking to see if he can get something going offensively, as he is 0-for-1 on the day. Still batting .330 as the lefty steps in against McDaniel. Lindsay gets a short lead. Harrison squares to bunt but pulls back. Ball still called a strike. As Harrison trying to move Jackson Lindsay into scoring position, potentially for Presley Walker. Let's see what he's going to do on an 0-1 count. Harrison doesn't square back, but instead hits a line drive into left center field, which is going to send Jackson Lindsay from first all the way to third. And Ramey Harrison has got it going, as UAH now has a runner in on the corners with nobody out here in the bottom of the fifth inning. That's the reason why you don't make him swing or bunt, because he's able to hit that line drive. Actually, I say that totally facetiously, because he is fantastic at bunting the baseball. In fact, he's one of the better bunters for UAH, which is definitely a lost craft in 2024. So now Presley Walker has an opportunity to get an RBI, which would be his 11th of the season, as he steps into the right-hand batter's box with nobody out in the bottom of the fifth inning. And the first pitch is swung on and missed, and he is now behind in the count 0-1. Presley Walker, who wasn't really starting very much in left field, instead it was Hunter Tillman, but instead Presley's been playing tremendously lately and is now starting to really get the start in left field, as he fouls the second pitch back to get behind 0-2 in the at bat. At one point in time in the season, he was batting 214, but he's moved that batting average all the way up to 271. And now he hits a line drive into right field that is going to be caught by Jacob Pager. But Jackson Lindsey is going to tag up, go home, throw not going to be in time. And UAH has tied it up on the sack fly from Presley Walker. Great situational hitting by Presley Walker to hit the ball oppo. Ramey Harrison stayed at first base, so now UAH has tied the ball game up. They still have a runner on first base and only one out in the inning to go back to the top of the lineup in Caleb Mahan. McDaniel pitches, and instead the breaking ball held by Logan Stockton, but Ramey Harrison steals second base on the no throw as Stockton dropped the baseball as he was trying to throw to second base. So now UAH looking at a runner in scoring position as Mahan steps into the right hand batter's box, quickly down 0-1 in the at bat. Mahan squares the bunt, pulls it back. Breaking ball then was called for a strike, so now he's looking at being down in the count 0-2. Mahan, unfortunately, if there is one thing about his game that he does need to improve on, it is breaking down and trying to not strike out as much, as he's already struck out once in this ball game, trying to not make it two times. Now he hits a fly ball, which is foul, but Kobe Jones is going over, or should say Justin Barnes is going over into foul territory, but the wind plays tricks on him and he is unable to make the catch. And so Caleb Mahan gets an extra life now in the top or the bottom of the fifth inning. As you can tell for Justin Barnes, as he was trying to make that catch, you can hear the wind blowing the way that it is right now. It will play tricks, especially when that ball is hit as high up as that one was by Caleb Mahan. An easy fly ball, it becomes dancing. As a matter of fact, Justin Barnes looks over into the shorter dugout and kind of does a motion with his hands to say the ball was dancing as it was coming down. Harrison gets his lead from second base as Mahan takes the ball now on the 0-2. To make the count 1-2. As he steps back in, as UAH has one out in the inning, they've already plated one in the inning, and they have the second run 180 feet away and represented by Ramey Harrison. As ball in the dirt, stopped by Logan Stockton, and the count is now even at 2 on the center fielder. Mahan showing a lot of patience against McDaniel, who McDaniel has and will put runners on the base with a lot of base on balls. Mahan just got to stay patient at the plate. McDaniel delivers and swung on and hit to shortstop from Caleb Mahan, and Mahan will get to first base on the error by Thomas Schroeder, which is number 52 on the year. Actually, correction, 53 on the year for Schroeder, as they are one of the worst teams in the Gulf South Conference in fielding. They already have 53 errors so far on the year, and this one results in Ramey Harrison getting to third base and Caleb Mahan getting to first. So now in steps Merrick Carter with an opportunity to add another run to the total for the UAH Chargers, potentially with 3 if he can get one in the air. McDaniel's first pitch to Carter is a breaking ball outside. As Mahan is standing at first base, Ramey Harrison is at third base after the error by the shortstop for Schroeder, Thomas Schroeder. That's a lot of S's. Breaking ball from McDaniel is going to be a called strike on Merrick Carter. Definitely not what he's looking for and what he wants it to do in that one. But he does have a big hole on the right side of the field with second base more in a double play depth than the first baseman. holding the runner on, but Carter hits a foul ball that is going to fly down the left field line, but is going to get down before Kobe Jones can get to it, as the hit and run was on for UAH. But Mahan back at first base with his hands on his knees. Any runner, and I'm telling you, any runner that runs on a hit and run and is not successful is so annoyed when they have to run back to first base after that, because now they've ran like crazy and it didn't result in anything, as the 1-2 pitch to Merrick Carter is going to be taken for a ball outside, breaking ball by McDaniel, and Carter has now even up the count with one out in the top or the bottom of the fifth inning. As Carter hits a hard line drive down the right field line, that's going to drop and hit one hop the wall. In comes Harrison. In comes Caleb Mahan. But he's going to stop at third base as he goes back to the bag. And Merrick Carter has given UAH a one-run lead in the fifth inning. Carter with yet another double after the hard line drive down the right field line, which plates one, and now you have another runner on third base with an opportunity for UAH to take a two-run lead, as they only have one out so far here in the bottom of the fifth inning. As McDaniel came into this inning, he had only thrown 66 pitches. He has already thrown 17 just in this inning alone, as his pitch total has worked its way up to 83 total pitches. And Shorter, looking down in their bullpen, which is right down the third baseline, they have some guys stretching, but nobody at the moment is warming up. So McDaniel doesn't have to look over his shoulder at the moment, as Carson Vialta steps into the left-hand batter's box. McDaniel's first pitch to Vialta will be going inside, as Vialta loves to stand extremely close to the plate, which is the reason why he's been hit 17 times this season. But if he gets a hit, it could result in two runs, as Merrick Carter is standing at second base and Caleb Mahan is standing at third base. Instead, he takes a breaking ball for a called strike to even the count at one apiece. Now, looking at trends as a pitcher pitches, that is multiple times in this ball game that Cole McDaniel has started an at-bat off with a ball thrown and followed it up with a breaking ball strike. Just taking note of that as UAH goes and continues throughout this game. Carson Vialta fouls the 1-1 pitch behind him directly, which is unique as well, because his hand came off the bat. He looks down at it like he may need some more stickum on his bat with his batting gloves, which is a necessary evil, unfortunately. Sometimes you hate the stickum because it's going to get all over everything and everything becomes sticky, but at the same time, you sometimes need it during these at-bats because it helps you keep your hand on the bat in certain situations like this one. 1-2 to the lefty, as the next pitch is going to be a called ball high, as UAH has runners in scoring position. Two ducks on the pond, one at second, one at third. As Vialta steps back into the left-hand batter's box with an even 2-2 count. McDaniels fires, swung on and missed, and that is a strikeout on Carson Vialta, as that is the second out of the inning. So here we go with Brock Butler, who is in a situation that he has been fairly good at over the course of the last few weeks, as he has an RBI streak that is running up to 5 or 6 baseball games now from the right side, as he has been hitting. With runners on base, he is batting .310 right now, and he is looking to improve that average. He swings at the first pitch and is going to be fouled and may even land on the press box, as you were able to hear right here. He has come to the plate 46 separate times with runners in scoring position, just like they are right now. And Brock Butler is batting .348 on the year. He actually bats better with runners in scoring position. as the 0-1 pitch is going to be fouled backwards. I should say the 0-2 pitch is fouled backwards. And he is now trying to stay alive. Two outs in the inning. UAH has already put two across, and they have two more on the base pass with Caleb Mahan standing at third base and Merrick Carter 90 feet behind him at second. McDaniels delivers the 0-2. He's going to be taken for a ball that almost became a pass ball, but Logan Stockton was able to jump up and make the catch. With the way that the backstop here is at UAH and the concrete that is back up against the backstop, that ball actually may have not resulted in a run because it would have went off the backstop and maybe shot directly back to Logan Stockton, who would have been a great position to tag out Mahan if Mahan would have tried it. The 1-2 is going to be into the left buttocks of Brock Butler. It actually may have been the thigh, but it still results in a base on ball being hit by a pitch. And now Brock Butler is standing at first base and the bases are now loaded for J.C. Wilbur. And I'll be honest with you, as a runner right now, Brock Butler is okay with being at first base, but the major thing for him that he is upset about is the fact that he had runners in scoring position and he was unable to get those in. That is what is going to upset him right now, because he had runners at second and third and he was unable to get those across. But as Shorter is talking about everything on the mound, let's look around the Gulf South Conference. Right now, Mississippi College is in Memphis taking on Christian Brothers. They hold an 11-4 lead in the first game of that series. Valdosta State is all over Delta State. And I want to double check this score. And nothing against Valdosta State, but at the moment, the Gulf South Conference website is saying that Valdosta State has put up 10 runs in the first inning against Delta State. I'm okay with that as somebody that does not like Delta State at all. I will lovely and proudly watch Delta State get their tails kicked every single week. But just to see that Valdosta State is up 10 to nothing right now, I just want to make sure that game is actually in the first inning, because at the moment, those are the only three games, counting ours, that are currently going on around the Gulf South Conference. As the meeting is over and J.C. Wilburn steps into the right-hand batter's box with the bases loaded in the bottom of the fifth inning with two outs. First pitch is going to be a breaking ball in the dirt, stopped by Stockton, but now J.C. Wilburn's looking at a 1-0 count here in the fifth. He's already flied out in this one. He has walked as well, which a walk would result in a run. Although when you're in this situation for him, he does not want that. He wants himself a line drive. He wants multiple RBIs. As he fouls one down the right field line, that one's going to travel out of bounds. And out of bounds, like this is basketball. It's going to go out of play, and it's going to head over to the UAH batting cages. And now Wilburn steps back into the right-hand batter's box with a 1-1 count here in the fifth. McDaniel at the belt and fires. That's going to be high outside, ball two. And Will Knowles is standing on deck. He's got his shin guards on because there are two outs in the inning, but he could come to the plate if Wilburn can get a base hit and score multiple runs in this at bat. Sharp ground ball down the third base line is going to go foul, and now we do it all over, we get to go again, because now the count is even at two apiece with two outs in the fifth inning for UAH. And it's my favorite line because two's across the board, two balls, two strikes, two outs. UAH has played it two. They also have two errors, so does Shorter. There's a lot of twos right now. And J.C. Wilburn is trying to get two in with a base hit. Let's see if he can do it. As he swings and misses on the breaking ball outside, and Shorter keeps it to just two runs. But as we head to the sixth, it is now UAH leading Shorter 2-1. You are listening to Charger Baseball, 97.7 ESP in the Zone.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is. is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
So after five, we are heading to the sixth inning. Now UAH leads 2-1. As his first at bat resulted in a long fly out to Presley Walker to the warning track, which without this hard wind blowing would have definitely been out here at Charger Park. Instead, now he is looking at an 0-1 count after fouling the first pitch from Will Tarpley behind us at Charger Park. And now the righty steps back in. And I feel, as a former catcher, this is one of the situations, it doesn't anger you. It just kind of annoys you. And I'll explain after this pitch. As he hits a ground ball foul. Because in the last inning, Stockton had to work extremely hard behind the plate. Because McDaniel's ball's in the dirt above his head. Stockton was having to make sure no runs were being scored. He was trying to stop all the pitches from McDaniel. And then he turns around. He has to be the first batter of the inning. You just want a break if you're the catcher. As the 0-2 pitch is going to be high, you just want a little bit of a break. Just give a breather, get some Gatorade, take a drink, take a breath, and then, you know, at least be the second batter so you can catch your breath. But instead, you got to come up and bat. Now he's behind in the count 1-2. He fouls off another pitch down the third baseline. And I can almost guarantee you, I'm not Will Knowles, but I promise you right now, if Will Knowles was mic'd up as the 1-2 pitch, it's going to be called strike three. Stockton wants to argue a little bit on that one with Wallace, but as the catcher, you don't want to do that because you want that call. I know Stockton's going to question it, and he's going to say, look, I don't think that was a strike, but instead, just take it, go back to the dugout, and then just remember it just in case your pitcher at some point in time is going to need that exact same call. By arguing it, you hurt yourself later on in the ball game. So one out now in the top of the sixth inning. Thomas Schroeder the fourth, which honestly you can't even really say his name like that, and that kind of, you just gotta go like Thomas Schroeder the fourth, because when you say the fourth, it's just gotta be all proper. As now Thomas Schroeder the fourth is looking at a 2-0 count as the Will Tarpley has fallen behind quickly in this one. First called strike for Tarpley on 2 Schroeder. Schroeder 1-for-1 in this ballgame. He has singled, he has walked, he's also had an error in the field at shortstop. But now he's looking at a 3-1 count as the next pitch from Tarpley is a little high and outside. Tarpley working extremely fast. Gets a called strike two to load and full the count up. Full the count up isn't really a thing. It's just the load. The call's loaded, but Schroeder then hits a hard line drive down the third base line, which is going to go foul. The unique thing about what just happened is as we're sitting here, we look out onto Charger Park and the setup that the infield and outfield currently have for Schroeder. Schroeder's a right-hand batter. But Presley Walker was playing him more into the gap as they're playing him as more as an oppo hitter. because that is going to be a called ball four as Schroeder is now heading down to first base. But Caleb Mahan and J.C. Wilburn are more shaded toward the right-hand side, normally like what you would do for a left-handed batter. Presley Walker was closer to left center field, so if that line drive would have gotten down the left field line, that would have resulted in at least two. But instead, Schroeder takes ball four. He's now standing at first base, and Cody Kraus steps in after striking out twice earlier in the ballgame. First pitch from Tarpley is going to be a called ball, as UAH is getting a little bit of work going in the bullpen. As we're about to see some sidearm action here in just a little bit, the lefty delivers. Fouled on by Kraus, could stay in play. Ramey Harrison is going, slides as he is on the warning track, but he didn't need to. Ramey Harrison made a bad decision on that one, and he thought that he was actually going to be closer to the ball in the dugout than what he was. And instead, the ball drops, and now that is just going to be a long strike. He actually had an opportunity to make the catch if he stays on his feet and continues running. But trying to make that play in the dugout, especially the visitor's dugout, is a little bit more difficult. Tarpley's 1-1 pitch is going to be outside for a called ball. And Thomas Schroeder quickly gets a lead at first base as Tarpley throws over to first base now. Not in time, but very close to getting Schroeder at first on the pickoff. Schroeder so far on the season, not as many stolen bases as some of his other teammates, but he's looking to be aggressive here in the sixth inning. As Kraus swings and misses on the 2-1, now to even the count at two apiece. Schroeder just trying to keep the attention of the lefty on the mound, try to get Kraus a good pitch, but instead the breaking ball from Tarpley is fouled into the backstop. And the count will remain two apiece at the moment as well. Got to pay attention to Will Tarpley's pitch count because he is at the 115 mark after that last pitch. And he is starting to get up higher. That's why UAH does have a pitcher going in the bullpen right now. Kraus, the 9-hole hitter. Right after him is going to be Jacob Pager. Nobody out so far in this inning for the Shorter Hawks. Tarpley looks over to first, throws back over to first. Schroeder dives back in, safe. Tarpley trying to keep Schroeder close. As Tarpley delivers a called strike three, and that is the third strikeout on the day for Cody Kraus. And now UAH has one out in the inning. On that strikeout looking, though, another thing that we're paying attention to at Charger Park is Tarpley has thrown, and as he was throwing, has fallen multiple times from the hill. Now, that could be a result of a few things, one of which being the hole that he's stepping in. He may be going a little bit to the right and causing his ankle to twist a little bit, which is definitely not something that you want. Or he could just be throwing with so much torque that his cleat is not catching whenever it goes down, resulting in him to fall. But either way, he's still getting the job done. He's only given up one run in this ballgame, which is unearned because of the error that we had earlier in this one. But Tarpley now has two outs. And he's quickly heading this one, 0-1 to Jacob Pager. The right fielder takes the ball to even the count at one apiece. So far on this day, though, Jacob Pager, 2-for-3. He's gotten a double. He's gotten a single. He has flied out. But he's trying to keep this inning alive for the Shorter Hawks. And honestly, with the speed of this team, anything in the gaps could actually score Thomas Schroeder from first base. But instead, Jacob Pager takes a called strike to now get to being behind in the count, 1-2, with two outs in this one. Tarpley, his 120th pitch coming, and it could be the final one of the inning and possibly even the game for him. as that is swung on and missed in the breaking ball, results in a strikeout, and Tarpley gets out of another one with leaving a man on the base pass. So as we head to the bottom of the inning, UAH has a one-run lead as they lead 2-1. You are listening to Charger Baseball on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
2-1 is the score from Charger Park as we are heading into the bottom of the sixth inning. UAH sitting on that 2-1 score after scoring two runs in the bottom of the fifth. Will Tarpley has thrown 120 pitches in this one, and his day could be done. As it looks as UAH has a pitcher ready in the bullpen, so we'll see how the seventh is going to go. But Cole McDaniel is still going for the shorter Hawks. He is getting close to his 100-pitch mark as well. He is now at 98 pitches on the afternoon, and potentially number 99 and 100 is going to go to the Rainbow City native as Will Knowles is going to lead this one off for UAH. It was wild because Will on the day has now 1-for-2. He's doubled in this one. He's grounded out. And up until his last at-bat where he did double into left center field, he actually had more triples on the season than what he did doubles, which is extremely unique for a catcher, albeit it was only 2-1. But still, he had more triples and doubles until just a few minutes ago where he doubled for his second one of the year as Cole McDaniels delivers the first pitch to Will Knowles as he swings and fouls that one right off of his leg. Cole McDaniel, I've said, has been throwing from the stretch. It's really kind of a modified windup, which you'll see a lot of pitchers kind of do, where the lefty will have his left foot on the rubber. He will barely take his right foot and move it just barely back a little bit into more of a windup motion. It's not much of a movement, but then it will try to result in a little bit more momentum for the pitch as it is being thrown. As he throws a breaking ball, Knowles hits it to left field where Kobe Jones is going and doesn't have to move very much for the first out of the bottom of the sixth inning. So we were right about that. It was the first and second pitch, which was the 99th and 100th of the game for Cole McDaniel. Went to Will Knowles, and now Jackson Lindsey is stepping in. 1-for-2 on the day. Had a tremendous series last week in West Georgia, as the first pitch to Jackson Lindsey was a breaking ball. Now, I want to see in this opportunity, because we talked about it earlier, 1-0 count, lefty. McDaniel's known for throwing breaking balls. This time, he does throw another one, more of a cutter that is swung on from Jackson Lindsey and fouled backwards as to even the count at one apiece. As the lefty goes into his modified windup, and the 1-1 pitch is going to be high for a ball. Jackson Lindsey, I say twerked at it, weird word to use right there, but made a small throwing motion, but didn't commit, or swinging motion, but didn't commit. And then the 2-1 pitch from McDaniel now results in another strike to even the count at two apiece with one out in the bottom of the sixth inning. First baseman awaits. The 2-2 is going to take a breaking ball for a ball to full up the count. So 3-2 now on the first baseman as he's trying to be the first base runner of the inning for the Chargers. McDaniel fires. Lindsey fouls it back. We'll do it all over again. Lindsey had two home runs in West Georgia last weekend. 1-for-2 on the day. And now he's going to be heading to first base with his first walk of the day. So after getting the count full, Jackson Lindsey makes his way to first base on the walk. And in steps Ramey Harrison, who is now also 1-for-2 on the day. He has struck out looking. But the lefty has also singled in this ball game, and if he does so in this opportunity, Jackson Lindsey may have enough speed that he could score from third base, depending on where the ball goes. Third baseman steps and waits, breaking ball on the outside is going to be too low for a ball in the dirt. Logan Stockton makes the stop. And now Ramey Harrison is in ahead in the count 1-0. Now, once again, McDaniel is behind in the count. He threw a breaking ball 1-0 last time. This time he's going to throw a fastball, but it's going to go outside, and now he's behind in the count 2-0. As you know, we're looking for trends, especially this late in the ball game, that maybe UAH has picked up on when it comes to McDaniels and the way that he does throw. 2-0 pitch on the way, and Harrison fouls that one out of play down the third base line. Not going to make it past the fences here at Charger Park and get into the parking lot, but it's going to be out of play. And now Harrison will step back into the left-hand batter's box ahead in the count 2-1. McDaniels, breaking ball, is going to be a called strike on the inside corner. So the count now even on Ramey Harrison. Harrison batting in the left-hand batter's box. Instead of having an open stance, he has a much more of a closed stance where the one on his back is actually looking at McDaniels. And Harrison hits a line drive that's going to go into left center field. Jackson Lindsey is going to be to third base, and Ramey Harrison once again has lined a ball directly over Schroeder's head and is going to go into left center field, is going to put runners on the corners for Presley Walker. Another line drive. Jackson Lindsey advances on that to get to third base. And now Presley Walker steps up. He only has one out. Last time he was in this situation, he had a sack fly to Jacob Pager in right field that scored UAH's first run, and which was Jackson Lindsey at third base. So very similar situation to what he had in the fifth inning. Let's see if there's going to be the same result. Walker steps into the right-hand batter's box as Ramey Harrison gets his lead at first, Lindsey at third. Fastball is going to be high and outside. McDaniels now getting close to 115 pitches himself. 75 strikes that he has thrown. But instead, after the first pitch of the at-bat to Presley Walker to make it 1-0, something that's very unique, you don't see happen a lot, but Shorter is going to go to the bullpen. Now in the middle of an at-bat, which is so incredibly annoying if you're Presley Walker. But when we come back, we'll see who's coming in for the Shorter Hawks. As right now in the bottom of the sixth inning, UAH has runners on the corners with one out as they try to add to this lead in the first game of a three-game series against the Shorter Hawks. You're listening to Charger Baseball, 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
So after falling behind 1-0 in the at-bat to Presley Walker, Shorter has went to the bullpen and they are heading, and they are going to be bringing in Blaine Fritcher, the junior from Lexington, Texas. As we talked about to start the ball game, how high of an ERA Shorter has when pitching, Fritcher's kind of helped with that, as he's got a 5.23 ERA on the season. A couple of weeks ago, down in West Florida, down in Pensacola, Fritcher gave up 7 runs and 10 hits in 5 innings of work, and he only saw a little bit of action against Montevallo last weekend after going 3 innings in that one, only giving up a run. But so far on the season, he has pitched in 32 innings. He has given up 19 runs, and now he steps in already behind in a count 1-0 to Presley Walker, with UAH having runners on the corners. So Ramey Harrison makes his way back to first base, and Jackson Lindsay heads back to third base as Fritcher is going to wrap up his throwing and get ready for this at bat to Presley Walker, which up until about, let's look at my watch, it's 5:05, so 5:03 p.m. I never knew Lexington, Texas was a thing, but that is where Fritcher is from. And Presley Walker is getting back into the right-hand batter's box, already up in the count 1-0. As Fritcher's first throw is actually going to go to first base to try to keep Ramey Harrison a little bit closer. Harrison dives back and gets back in the bag in time, just gets dirty. As UAH only has 1 out in the inning. The first pitch from Fritcher, and Presley Walker hits a high fly ball to left field, but it's not going to be deep enough to get Jackson Lindsay in, as Cody Krause and Kobe Jones both meet, not so much just collide, they just have a conversation, and Krause makes the catch after calling Jones off, and there is now 2 outs in the inning. Presley tried to do what he could to get the runner home from third base, but was unable to get it deep enough. And instead, we head back to the top of the batting order for the UAH Chargers. And Caleb Mahan, who has been a fighter in every single at-bat so far that he has seen today. He is only 1-for-3 in the game, but he has gotten on base on an error. He has singled, and he has struck out in this one. He's trying to keep the inning going. First pitch from Fritcher is going to be fouled back towards the concession stand here at Charger Park. And Caleb Mahan is going to be down 1-0 or 0-1 in this count. Mahan has gotten down 0-2 in multiple at-bats, been able to fight back. In fact, both times he's gotten on base, he started out in those at-bats down 0-2. Fritcher, the righty, delivers. Mahan swings, misses. So here we go again. Mahan down in the count 0-2 again, but he's kind of comfortable in these situations. He's also struck out a lot in these situations, but he's also comfortable in this one because he's been down 0-2 so many times, especially in this ballgame. 2 outs in the inning as Fritcher throws the 0-2 and Mahan fouls it back into the net. Mahan back in the right-hand batter's box as Fritcher is set at the belt and delivers. As Mahan hits a ground ball to right field, that's going to score Jackson Lindsay. Ramey Harrison had to hold up to get the ball, let the ball go past him. And now UAH has runners on first and second. Caleb Mahan, once again, comfortable in 0-2 situations, gets yet another hit to right field. Saying it's something you want to be in, but to be comfortable in an 0-2 situation is a fantastic thing for any coach, knowing that he's got a batter in the batter's box that is okay with that. So now UAH adding another run, going up 3-1, and Merrick Carter steps in and takes the ball from the first pitch from Fritcher. Ramey Harrison is at second base now. Caleb Mahan now 2 hits on this ball game. Now the run with Lindsay does not go to Fritcher. That still is on McDaniel, so we can't close the book on him just yet, as Merrick Carter takes a changeup for a strike. Ramey Harrison at second base is also counts towards Cole McDaniel. The only runner that Fritcher accounts for is Caleb Mahan. Fritcher fastball outside. Carter being patient. Now he's ahead in the count, 2-1 with two outs. The way that the infield is looking, they're shaded a little bit closer to a shift, but Schroeder isn't totally behind second base just yet as Fritcher throws to second to get Remy Harrison back. So Schroeder is, you have second baseman Norman Leon is normally where you would see in a shift, but with Schroeder, he's actually staying behind Remy Harrison for the pickoffs like what we just saw a second ago. Carter waits the 2-1 and takes for a ball, 3-1 in the count now. As Carson Vialta stands in the on-deck circle, wanting to get up and try to add a run to this, or more if he has the possibility to. Fritcher delivers a 3-1. Carter takes the 3-1, and now UAH has three runners on, which means the bases are loaded for Carson Vialta, who is 0-for-3 on this one. He's flied out twice. He has struck out. UAH has two outs in the inning. Number of different majors you can have. And Vialta on the season has only came to bat with the bases loaded three times, and he is 0-for-3 with the bases loaded. First pitch to Vialta was a called strike. He's down 0-1 in the count. Two outs, bottom of the sixth inning. UAH has already plated one. As Shorter now is in a shift in the infield, and Vialta swings at the next pitch and misses for strike two. Vialta, 290 hitter with two outs in an inning, and he's going to have to improve that average to keep this inning going now. As he fouls it back into Logan Stockton's glove, and that is a swinging strikeout. And UAH gets the bases loaded. They plate one and now add a run to the lead as we head to the seventh. UAH 3, Shorter 1. This is Charger Baseball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
3-1 is the score as UAH has a two-run lead on the Shorter Hawks as we are in the seventh inning. And Will Tarpley actually is continuing on the mound after throwing 120 pitches. And before we get going, I have to compliment our baseball SID at UAH, because this is something you may not know about, but we have SIDs that cover all these sports. And Tanner Mickey has handed me so many incredible stats. And anytime you hear these situational stats and stuff that we talk about during these ball games, it is 100% Tanner. And he does an absolutely amazing job here at UAH. He doesn't get enough love for it, and I want to make sure that you know about how great of an SID he is for the university. As the first pitch from Tarpley is a called ball, then the second pitch is going to be a called strike. Jacoby Jones has stepped in on the left-hand side. He's flown out twice. He's walked once, and now he's behind in the count, 1-2, as that pitch was a called strike on the outside corner as well. Tarpley well over 100 pitches now. This is his 124th that he's about to deliver on this 1-2 pitch. And that is going to be a ball, very close, but a little bit too far off the outside corner. And now the count is even at two apiece with nobody out in the top of the seventh. Ground ball to short. Merrick Carter makes it, bobbles it, throws it to first. Not going to be in time, as that is going to be Kobe Jones now standing at first base, awaiting the call. And it is going to be considered a hit for Kobe Jones as we look over, because there was a possibility of that being considered another error on Merrick Carter with a little bit of a bobble, but instead it goes down as a base hit. And Kobe Jones is standing on first base now with nobody out, and Alex Brody stepping into the batter's box. First pitch to Brody is going to be a breaking ball for a ball. And this is one of the batters for the shorter Hawks that you have to be careful with, because he does have 9 home runs on the year, as Tarpley falls down again on that 2-0 pitch, or that 1-0 pitch that he throws. He looks down at the hole that his cleats are normally stepping in. Throws a little bit of dirt there. And now I'm starting to kind of see what's going on with Tarpley on these throws, as the 2-0 pitch is going to be hit into left field. Presley Walker's going to come in, makes the catch as he dives, catches the first out of the inning. His glasses fall off of him. He gets it back into the infield as Kobe Jones stays at first base, and UAH now has one out in this inning. And Shorter continues to have that one runner on first base. But what's going on with Will Tarpley in this is with a pitcher, a lot of times you want him to always step in the exact same spot. You'll see it a lot of times, because every single motion that you see in baseball, you want the same motion all the time. As the first pitch to Justin Barnes is going to be high and outside. And with Will Tarpley, what's happening is, if you were to track where his cleats are landing on every single pitch, they're not landing in the same spot. So sometimes it lands in the hole, and sometimes it doesn't, as that pitch from Tarpley is going to be fouled back to even the count at one apiece, but it's also going to be another one that he fell down on because his cleats are not landing in the exact same spot. So if you're listening at Charger Park, you kind of see him falling, and as he goes towards the third base side on his downward motion, he's kind of falling down some, and that's due to the way that he's landing on his cleats. As the 1-1 pitch is going to be low for ball two. And Justin Barnes, who's 0-for-2 in this ball game, is now ahead in the count 2-1 to Tarpley. That 2-1 pitch was very close to a strike, but instead, Barnes is now looking at a 3-1 with one out. And you heard the catch and you heard the pause by me of me not saying anything, because I was still waiting to see the umpire call that a strike, like he just did that 3-1 pitch from Tarpley. Now the Snead State transfer has gotten the count back to full, as the 3-2 pitch comes to Barnes and he fouls it back in towards the softball fields here at Charger Park. And so Tarpley now over 130 pitches in this ball game. UAH has a man ready in the bullpen, so you have to think if Barnes possibly gets on, that this could result in Tarpley's day being over with. The throw over to first, not in time, as Jones gets back. But now he gets his lead with one out in the top of the seventh inning for Shorter. Here comes the full count pitch. Jones goes, and that is going to be ball four. And now Shorter has two men on, and Hunter Royer steps out of the first base dugout and is heading to the mound. Is this to get Tarpley, or is he going to give the pitcher an opportunity to try to pitch out of this one. No, he will look down the first base line, motion to the bullpen, and we will have a new pitcher. But Will Tarpley, 135 pitches in the ballgame. He has struck out seven, and he goes 6 1/3. When we come back, we'll tell you about the new UAH pitcher, as UAH and the Chargers have a 3-1 lead here in the seventh. You are listening to Charger Baseball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
So in comes Tanner Giles, the righty for the UAH Chargers. Not just a righty, he's the sidearm pitcher for the UAH Chargers, as Shorter has runners on first and second, as Tanner Giles continues to warm up. He's had a unique season because at the beginning of the year, going all the way up to February 24th, he did not have an ERA, even though he had pitched in about six innings out of the bullpen. Then they played Tuskegee on the 28th of the year. He gave up a run there. And now he is sitting at a 4.58 ERA, where his ERA has jumped up. What really hurt him was in the loss to Montevallo just 2 weeks ago, where he only threw six pitches in the ball game. He did not get a single out, but he did give up two earned runs. A couple of weekends ago against Lee, he pitched in a little over an inning and a third. He gave up two runs there. Now, against West Georgia last weekend, he did pitch in the loss to West Georgia in that Friday night ball game, but he pitched at 1 1/3 and did not give up a run there. So as he steps in on and steps onto the right, onto the rubber, the righty is trying to get UAH out of this inning. Great thing about sidearm pitchers is that two-seam fastball is way more of a sinker, which is what UAH is looking for to try to get a ground ball and get out of this inning. The first pitch to Griffin Clark is going to be a called strike one on the inside corner. Merrick Carter and Carson Vialta is in double play depth. Caleb Mahan and J.C. Wilburn still shaded over to the right with the wind blowing hard to the right, but Presley Walker looks like a man out by himself in left field as the 0-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and Griffin Clark is down in the count 0-2. He struck out in this one, he's walked in this one, and he's grounded out. Another ground out could be the end of the inning, as he does hit a ground ball to Vialta, over to Carter to Lindsey, but Merrick Carter does not get the double play because the throw to Lindsey was too high. Great job by Jackson Lindsey, but now the umpire is saying that the runner heading to second is going to be called for interference. UAH is going to get the double play and get out of the inning. So no error on Merrick Carter on the throw, but that does mean that UAH gets out of the inning and now is still leading this one as they head into the bottom of the seventh, up 3-1. You are listening to Charger Baseball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does. And they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida. From first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
So rumor interference gets UAH out of the jam, and Tanner Giles comes in, gets a ground ball for the double play, and now UAH heads into the bottom of the seventh inning, up 3-1, as Blaine Fritcher is now stepping onto the mound for his first full inning of work after coming in to face Presley Walker in the last inning and getting out of the inning after only giving up one run for UAH to take that three-run lead. But this inning, he's going to see Brock Butler in that four-hole, J.C. Wilburn after that, and Will Knowles is in the hole at the three spot for the inning. Brock Butler has not gotten a hit so far in this one. He is 0-2, though. He has been hit by a pitch that loaded the bases up earlier in this ballgame. And so he wants to do a little bit more. He's got a multiple game hitting streak going right now. He has a multiple game RBI streak going right now. And he is trying to keep both of those alive here in the seventh inning, which could be close to his last at bat. But Fritcher is now finished with his warm-up throws, and the junior from Meridian, Mississippi, makes his way to home plate. Don't forget, we've got a doubleheader tomorrow here as well. You'll be able to listen to that on 97.7 ESPN The Zone 2. So download this ESPN The Zone 2 or the Zone app where you can listen to. We have a Zone 2, 3, 4, 5, all of those you're going to need during the fall for high school football here on ESPN The Zone. First pitch from Fritcher, and Brock Butler hits a deep fly ball to left field. Kobe Jones is coming over. So is Cody Krause, and Krause is going to make the catch in left center field. And I know exactly what Brock Butler is thinking, because this is one of those days where you're going to think that, but with the wind blowing as hard as it is from left to right, that ball that Brock Butler just hit probably stayed in the ballpark simply because of the wind. It is playing that big of a factor now in this ballgame, as J.C. Wilburn awaits the first pitch of his at-bat, and that's going to be swung on and fouled. He is 0-2 on the day. He has also walked in this one. And he's playing right field, which is not a very easy position to play, as Jacob Pager is playing it right now, and he's working on his swing in right field. Fritcher delivers, ball outside. Which, look, I can't fault Jacob Pager on that. As playing in, playing outfield as long as I did, including my time here at UAH, when you're in the outfield a lot of times, you've got to keep yourself busy, because there's not a lot of action sometimes, especially in right field. Fritcher delivers. Wilburn, I guess we'll call that a swing. It wasn't pretty, but it was a swing. And now he's down in the count 1-2. The outfield's one of those difficult positions, because if you're hard of paying attention, which I am ADHD, playing the outfield, you've got to find ways to entertain yourself. The 1-2 from Fritcher is going to be hit hard by Wilburn, but is going to be right at the center fielder, Cody Krause. And that is the second out of the inning. So Wilburn did well when it came to staying back on that outside pitch. And he did try to take it oppo, but he only was able to get it to center field. And Krause barely even had to move in center field to make that catch. And now UAH has two down here in the inning. And Will Knowles is going to be responsible for keeping this one alive. 1-for-3 on the day. He has doubled. And the lefty awaits the first pitch from Fritcher, which is going to be a breaking ball outside. See, when you're in the infield, it's so much easier because every single pitch, you've got to pay attention because a line drive can take your head off. As Fritcher delivers the 1-0, and that one's going to be low and inside. So Knowles is ahead in the count 2-0. So shorter right now for Griffin Clark, Thomas Schroeder, Norman Leon, and even Justin Barnes. They have to be involved in every single pitch. As Knowles swings on the 2-0 for a strike. But in right field, especially when a lot of times you're not facing a ton of lefties, which UAH does have a good number of those, you got to stay busy. Fritcher throws, and Will Knowles has a bad swing on that one as well. Misses, and now he has an even count as he now awaits the 2-2 with two outs here in the top, or I should say the bottom of the seventh inning. Fritcher then takes a line drive from Knowles off of his ankle. Knowles is going to be safe at first base. That's going to go down as a hit, and now everybody wants to make sure that Fritcher is okay because he had zero time to react to that line drive coming off of, I'm trying to see if it was his ankle or if it was more of his calf, because he was still in his throwing motion and his foot had barely touched the ground when his plant foot took the line drive off of the leg. So Fritcher's walking around right now as Knowles is in and at first base. The training staff for Shorter is out to check on the pitcher, and they're going to give him an opportunity. You're most likely also, if you're sitting here at Charger Park and you're listening on 97.7 ESPN The Zone 2, or if you're watching on YouTube, Fritcher's probably going to have an opportunity to throw if he is going to be staying in the inning. But looking around right now, let's look around as the umpire and everybody is talking and checking on the pitcher. Let's look around the Gulf South Conference on this Friday afternoon, because Mississippi College is up in Memphis taking on Christian Brothers. And at the moment, Mississippi is up 11-4. In this ball game, what we are seeing is UAH is leading 3-1. There's only a few games that have also gotten started so far on this afternoon. Now, I'm going to pause on these scores because Fritcher is being taken out of the ball game, and Shorter is going to be bringing in a new pitcher. So when we come back, we'll let you know who that new pitcher is, and we'll continue giving you some scores around the Gulf South Conference, because some of these games are very important to UAH Charger fans as the Chargers are trying to move up from that 12 spot to get to that number 8 spot to make sure that they will be heading to Oxford for the Gulf South Conference Tournament. You are listening to UAH Baseball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Bill Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Bill Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Bill Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Bill Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at BillPennyToyota.com. Bill Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
Wake up and text. Text and eat. Text and meet up with a friend you haven't seen in forever.
Hi.
Oh, hey. Text and complain that they're on their phone the whole time. Text and listen to them complain that you're on your phone the whole time. Text and whatever. But when you get behind the wheel, give your phone to a passenger. Put it in the glove box. Just don't text and drive. Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
So with two outs in the bottom of the seventh inning, Will Knowles hits a line drive off Blaine Fritcher's calf muscle, which results in the pitcher having to be taken out of the ball game by Shorter. And now Shorter has brought in the Atlanta native Matt Navarro to try to finish up this inning. Now, this is kind of a specialty for Matt Navarro because he has pitched in 8 2/3 innings so far this season. But in 7 of his appearances, he has pitched in less than a full inning. So he's come in situations where Shorter has only need one or two outs. In fact, he has only pitched an inning or more 3 separate times so far this season. And again, he's only thrown in 8 2/3 innings total in 2024. Now, he does have a 5.19 ERA, but he has yet to give up multiple runs in over a month. Last time he gave up multiple runs was back in March against AUM, where he did so on March 9th. And now he comes in to face the lefty Jackson Lindsay with Will Knowles standing at first base with two outs in the bottom of the seventh. Navarro fires. The lefty hits, throws one in the dirt as Will Knowles is going to advance to second base on the wild pitch. Stockton did everything that he possibly could on that, but he was unable to keep it in front of him, and that results in Knowles making it down to second. So Navarro's first pitch is going to be in the dirt. Jackson Lindsay is going to be ahead in the count 1-0 as Will Knowles is clapping because he knows that Lindsay can put one in the outfield. UAH is going to add to the lead. Navarro's next pitch is going to be inside for a ball. Lindsay so far on the day is 1-for-2. He's walked in this one as well. The first baseman having a tremendous week so far after playing extremely well in West Georgia last week as he takes a pitch outside, but it is called a ball, so not something he wants to look at and try to swing at ahead in the count 2-0. So instead, it's a 2-1 count. There are two outs. Shorter is playing an extreme shift for the lefty as Navarro fires the 2-1. It's going to be a ground ball that is hit, and I mean this 100%, directly to Thomas Schroeder as he was barely standing behind second base, and that is going to result in the third out of the inning. So Navarro comes in, he gets his one out, maybe the end of his day. We'll see coming up in the bottom of the eighth, but UAH still has a 3-1 lead as we are heading in to the last six outs as UAH is trying to take game one of this three-game series against Shorter. You are listening to UAH Baseball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Tanner Giles is going to come in for his first full inning of work after replacing Will Tarpley in the seventh inning, as UAH has a 3-1 lead in the eighth inning. For Shorter, you're going to see 6-7-8, Norman Leon, Logan Stockton, and Thomas Schroeder the fourth. That means that if UAH can get out of this one, that they will head into the ninth inning and they will see the top of the lineup for Shorter. And what UAH has so far done in this ballgame to keep Shorter at just one run and only a couple of stolen bases, both of which happened on double steals, then what UAH has done so far in this one is tremendous. As Tanner Giles' first pitch is going to be low and inside. The sidearm righty is already back on the hill, ready to pitch. 1-0 is going to be low and outside now as he's behind in the count 2-0 to Norman Leon. Leon hasn't had the best season so far. He's still batting 245. He's 0-for-3 on the day so far. Three straight groundouts, all of which have went to Ramey Harrison. And now he takes a called strike as he was ahead in the count 2-0 to now make it 2-1. Leon trying to be patient and get on base as he now hits a ground ball to short. That's going to be caught by Merrick Carter, thrown over to first, and that's going to one hop, and Jackson Lindsay's not going to make the catch. It's going to go back to the fence, and Norman Leon is going to head to second base, as that is going to be an error. It's going to be an E3 on Jackson Lindsay, or E6, correction, as I'm getting the hand signals right now. sound like Tanner is my third base coach, but it's going to be an E6. And unfortunately, Merritt Carter has yet another error in this ball game. What's great is when you're in these situations and you're looking at the your score to see what he ends up scoring, this is sometimes you're looking and seeing how he is judging those calls. Tanner Giles is now ahead or behind in this count 1-0 as Norman Leon is going. So with Merritt Carter, he makes a tremendous catch on the short hop, but the throw is what cost him and got him to get the throwing error. So now Logan Stockton is trying to put one over into the practice soccer field that's behind the UAH Charger baseball field, and he swings and misses and is now looking at a 1-1 count with a runner on second and nobody out. Tanner Giles' 1-1 pitch is going to be a called strike low. The thing about Stockton is he's continuing to want to make comments about these calls when he's the catcher for shorter, and he needs to understand that these calls are not going to go his way if he continues to do this. Logan Stockton steps back in, though. Open stance as he looks at Giles. The sidearm pitch from Giles results in a high foul ball. Is it going to stay in play? No, it does not. It goes into the UAH bullpen at the UAH dugout as Jackson Lindsay slid, trying to make a catch, very similar to what Ramey Harrison did a couple of innings ago on the third base side, but the ball just went a little bit too far in that one and is uncatchable. So Logan Stockton is still going to have a 1-2 count. As the wind is continuing to pick up, Stockton, he is one of the batters today that has not really benefited from the way this wind is going, because the righty had put one that would have been over the fence if the wind had not been blowing. But Giles delivers a 1-2 that is fouled behind us and is going to go and head towards the ticket office at Charger Park. Great thing about it, Giles, again, with him being the sidearm pitcher, is this two-seam fastball, or his fastball in general, is going to have a little bit of a sink to it, could keep the ball on the ground as Logan Stockton is trying to continue to work this count. The next pitch is going to be a ball as well, so he's even the count at two apiece. As Merritt Carter is back and playing deep in the hole at short, Vialta trying to keep the runner on at second base, trying to keep him close. Giles 2-2 is going to be in the dirt. Will Knowles is going to stop it, but fantastic job by Norman Leon to be able to see the ball in the dirt, see it get away from Will Knowles, and to read it and to get to second base or to third base on the throw. So Norman Leon is now 90 feet away from getting shorter into a situation where they will only be down by one run. Nobody out in the inning. Full count on Logan Stockton. And Logan Stockton has put another charge into another baseball, but Presley Walker is going back. Once again, catches it right in front of the warning track. But this time, Norman Leon is going to be able to score, and now Shorter is only down 3-2. So another ball that Logan Stockton tried to take out of the yard may have actually done it again if it wasn't for this heavy wind. But once again, Presley Walker got underneath it in left field and was able to make the catch. But this one did result in a sac fly, scoring the run from third base. So in steps Thomas Schroeder the fourth, and he hits a line drive into the right center field gap. Caleb Mahan's going to cut it off, but he's unable to get to it with his glove, which results in Thomas Schroeder going to second base. Mahan, reading the line drive, overran the ball and put his hand out to stop it, did so, but that gave Thomas Schroeder an opportunity to round first base and get to second for the double on the play. And in doing so, Hunter Royer has stepped out of the first base dugout and is heading to talk to Tanner Giles. And that is going to be the day for the righty. So after 16 pitches, Tanner Giles' day is done. He is responsible for one run, and he has a runner on second base. But when we come back, tell you about the new UAH pitcher, as now UAH only leads 3-2 in the top of the eighth inning. You are listening to Charger Baseball on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
So Corey Haygood steps on the hill for your UAH Chargers. Correction on what I said at the very end of Tanner Giles' day, as a run is scored, but because he got on base due to a throwing error, that is actually not going to count as an earned run for Tanner Giles. But Tanner Giles is responsible for Thomas Schroeder, that is standing at second base right now. But Corey Haygood's job at the moment is to get two more outs and to keep this a 3-2 ball game heading into the ninth inning. Haygood on the season hasn't been amazing. This UAH pitching staff is one in which, regardless as to what happens over the next nine conference games, eight after today, they're going to want to improve their pitching going into 2025, because as great as the offense has been, the pitching staff is one that has struggled throughout the season. Haygood at the moment has a 6 ERA. The last time that Haygood pitched and did not give up an earned run was all the way back in February. February 21st against AUM was the last time that Haygood came in and did not give up an earned run. And he's going to try to do that today and keep this a 3-2 ball game. But in steps Cody Kraus, who is 0-for-3 on the day. He's got three strikeouts, two of them swinging, and Haygood delivers. The lefty's first pitch is high for a ball. As Cody Kraus is one of the pitchers in this, that are one of the batters in this, that could actually really benefit from hitting a high fly ball to the pole side, because that would be right field. But at the moment, as you can kind of hear it on our microphone, as he swings and misses to even the count at one apiece, the wind has died down as we've gotten into this eighth inning. It had been extremely heavy, especially early in the ball game. It was a major factor, and it was a major factor earlier in this inning as well, as the 1-1 pitch is going to be outside for a ball. And Haygood is now behind in the count 2-1. Wind starting to pick up a little bit more, which is more of a concern with Kraus. But Kraus squares to bunt a little bit lower, and Tanner would have been able to make the catch over to my right, as that went right back into his glove range. But instead, it is now a 2-2 count, as Haygood is trying to get his first out of the inning. As he looks back at second, Schroeder getting a little bit of a lead. Haygood making sure to keep him close. Schroeder hit so far in this ballgame, and you're going to hear about it and see it if you're watching on UAH's YouTube channel, he's been annoying on the base pass. And I mean that in a way to compliment him, because he is making sure that he continues to keep the pitcher's attention to throw off his pitches to Kraus. The 2-2 is going to be high, going to result in a full count now. He did it earlier in the game with Tarpley, and he's doing an amazing job at just getting slight leads and getting enough attention to either get a throwback to the bag at second, throwback to the bag at first, or to try to help Kraus get out of it. But instead, Kraus is going to be heading back to the dugout, and I'm looking because he is the recipient of the golden sombrero, as he has struck out for the fourth time today and the third time swinging. And Haygood now is one out away from keeping this a one-run lead for the UAH Chargers. But now we're back to the top of the lineup, and Jacob Pager, the right fielder, who's been working on his batting stance all afternoon in right field. But he's also 2-for-4, so I can't bash him about it because he's doing well. Fouls the first pitch from Haygood behind us. As I said, 2-for-4, he's doubled, he's singled, he's flown out, and he struck out. And if Haygood can get him out here, then UAH is going to at least come back in the top of the ninth inning to try to wrap this one up with at least a one-run lead. But the righty is waiting. Haygood. Haygood with a tremendous fastball in the inside corner of the plate, but Matthew Wallace, the home plate umpire, calls it a ball. Very close pitch by the lefty. Tremendous. It could, honestly, in a lot of situations, that could have been a called strike. But now Haygood has an even count and delivers. Fastball outside as he falls behind a Pager. Presley Walker all alone. There's not a single UAH Charger within 100 yards of him at the moment. And Pager gets a hold of one, but it is going foul and is going to go over the fence, but it is going over the foul portion, so it's just going to be a foul ball. But he got a hold of that, and with the wind dead at the moment, that was 100% home run distance by the right fielder. But instead, it's a 2-2 count, two outs in the inning, and Corey Haygood is now one pitch away from getting out of this jam for the UAH Chargers. Looks back to second and pitches. Fastball inside. That one's going to be called a ball as well, and now we've got a full count. Haygood looking at a full count with two strikes. There's only a runner on second base, so Schroeder is going to be standing still at the moment as the lefty gets ready to throw. And Pager hits another ball deep to left field. This one's not as deep as the last one. It's still going to go foul as this one lands in the shorter bullpen. And that is just a long foul ball. So far, Corey Haygood has come in with runners on the base pass and faced 65 different batters with runners on, and opposing batters are only batting 277 against him right now. And Pager hits another fly ball to left field. This time it's not getting out either as he throws the bat towards the shorter dugouts, angry at the fact that Presley Walker makes the catch and gets Haygood and the Chargers out of the inning. So Shorter puts up one to get within one, but UAH is heading to the bottom of the eighth inning up one as it is 3-2 here at Charger Park, and this is 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Heading to the bottom of the eighth inning as Matt Navarro comes in for his first full inning of work after coming in relief. In the bottom of the seventh, he is going to face 8-9-1 as Ramey Harrison is going to start this inning off for the Chargers. And it's going to be Presley Walker and Caleb Mahan in the door right now awaiting an opportunity to hit. The first pitch to Harrison is going to be a breaking ball called for strike one. Harrison 2-for-3 on the day. He's already got two singles, and he hits a ground ball weakly back to the pitcher as Navarro catches it, tosses it underhand over to the first baseman, and that is one out in the inning. So the lefty from Atlanta has gotten two outs so far during this game in his appearance, and he's trying to keep UAH at only three runs as Presley Walker steps in and takes a ball on the outside corner as the breaking ball just a little bit too far off the plate. 0-for-2 on the day. He's flied out twice, but he has an RBI on a sac fly. Now batting with nobody on, and he takes a second ball outside. Navarro fires, going to be high and outside again. Presley Walker's now worked this to a 3-0 count as UAH has nobody on and one out in the bottom of the eighth inning. They're at least going into the ninth with a one-run lead. As Walker taking all the way is going to be taking for ball four or strike one on that. And now swings at strike two to make the count full. Now it's a full count. Pitch from Navarro, and Walker fouls it back to the concrete here at Charger Park, which I believe Mahan caught on a one hopper. Mahan on deck. Or I should say, yes, Mahan on deck right now as Walker hits another foul ball, this time down the third baseline up against the tarp. Count's going to remain full. As the righty steps back in, awaits the pitch from the lefty Navarro, and he hits a hard ground ball to second. Norman Leon can't get it. That's going to go as a hit. Hard ground ball hit by Presley Walker. And the left fielder now standing at first base for Caleb Mahan. Hard line drive or hard ground balls are so difficult to read, especially with one in which that way, which short hop Norman Leon, he olayed it. It goes over his head and into the outfield. Don't blame him at all, because if you're don't know much about second base, second baseman has the smallest glove on the field. As Navarro's first pitch to Mahan is going to be a ball inside. So if Leon has an outfielder's glove, first baseman's glove, then he may have a little bit more confidence in trying to catch it. But if you just look at your hand, a second baseman glove may only go and be 2 or 3 inches above where your fingertips are. It is that small of a glove. As Mahan check swings and now has an even count at one apiece with Walker at first base. Navarro throws over to first to keep Walker close. So trust me, Leon on that one, that's a hard ball to catch for a second baseman with as hard as it is, and is even difficult on a short hop with a small glove. So Great hitting by Presley Walker with a full count to get that ball hit hard. And Mahan fouls off a pitch. And now here we are again with Caleb Mahan having two strikes. Now he's done well pitching, or I should say hitting, in two strike counts so far on the day, because he's been in multiple two strike counts. He is 2-for-4 on the day. He has struck out once. He's reached on an error. He's gotten on base three times, and now he hits a hard line drive or a hard ground ball up the middle. Walker is going to make it to second base, and Mahan's going to be safe at first base. And now UAH has two runners on with one out here in the bottom of the eighth inning. If you're shorter, the one thing that you're really wanting to pay attention to is how hard these balls are being hit. And I think that's exactly what Shorter's head coach is paying attention to, because it's not just that UAH is getting balls hit off of Navarro. It's the velocity that these balls are coming off of the bat, because they are making solid contact. Shorter knows that, and they're going to be heading to the bullpen as Navarro responsible for the runners on first and second, but his day is done on the mound. We'll tell you more about the new Shorter pitcher as UAH is threatening as they are up by one in the bottom of the eighth inning. You're listening to UAH Baseball 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
So Shorter brings in Caleb McGinnis, the righty from Hoke's Bluff, to try to get the Hawks out of this jam as UAH has runners on first and second. And McGinnis has pitched well in his last two opportunities on the mound. Now, a lot of times he has pitched this season, they have been against non-Gulf South Conference opponents. He has pitched in nine innings of work, or he's seen nine innings of work, but he has only been in a game against a Gulf South Conference opponent twice. One of those was against Lee, and one of those was against Christian Brothers. Correction, three times. I apologize. So we're going to see what he can do, as his last two outings have been against Morehouse and Southern Wesleyan, but both of those appearances have resulted in no runs scored. So we're going to see what McGinnis can do here. The first pitch from the righty is going to be low for a ball to Merrick Carter. Carter, 2-for-3 on the day. He's already raised that batting average, which is one of the best in the country, to .436. Looking to add some RBIs. The righty looks back to Walker and fires the 1-0 that is now a 2-0 pitch. So Carter is now looking for something, which honestly, with the way that the defense is set up, he still looks good if he can put something right over the second baseman's head, which a fastball instead is going to go right into his hip. And Merrick Carter is going to be walking to first base, and UAH is now going to have the bases loaded with one out and Carson Vialta up to bat. And this now goes to the amazing statistic that our SID Tanner pulled for us earlier in the day. And that is the unfortunate one that Carson Vialta has now came to the plate four different times in 2024 with the bases loaded, and he is 0-for-4 on the season. Let's see if he can change that. First pitch from McGinnis is going to be high and outside. Vialta 0-for-4 on the day. Came into this batting 362. It's already down to 351. But after the first pitch, Shorter is going to send out their pitching coach to talk to McGinnis. And in saying that, let's also give an opportunity to kind of look around the Gulf South Conference, as we have now had multiple games in progress, including ours here and the one that's happening right behind us with the UAH softball team. Now, the baseball game that we're currently in, if you're just now hopping in, 3-2 is the lead for UAH. Happening down in Montevallo, they are getting going. It's actually in the fifth inning, I should say, but it's still nothing. Valdosta State is all over Delta State as they currently lead 16-1 in the first game of that series. You also have AUM and West Georgia just getting going. That one is tied at 0-0 down in Montgomery, and Union and Lee don't play until 6 o'clock tonight. Now, right behind us, UAH is all over Shorter as both teams are here taking on the Chargers. The women's softball team is up 9-0, and Vialta doesn't get a hit with the bases loaded, but he gets hit with the bases loaded, which brings Presley Walker in. So Vialta heads to first base, still 0-for-4 with the bases loaded, but now he has an RBI on that. McGinnis, his day is now done. As, let me double check this, that is correct. After five pitches and five balls, McGinnis is done for the day, and we will have a new pitcher for the Shorter Hawks. It is now 4-2. UAH here in the bottom of the eighth inning. You are listening to Charger Baseball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I've personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
So Shorter's bringing in the tow truck as UAH now leads 4-2 and have the bases loaded. I joke about the tow truck only because Shorter has went to the righty, Landon Maynard. And I just want to say Mater every single time that I want to say his name. If I slip up over the course of the next however many pitches Maynard is in for, I deeply apologize. I only say it because he's a Wetumpka native and his family from Montgomery could be listening. And look, I'm a redneck from the backwoods of New Hope, Alabama. So I know Southern. But Maynard comes in with a 4.70 ERA. Saw some action against Morehouse earlier in the week, but before that had not seen action in almost 3 weeks, which was back in March of the year. And on the 23rd, he pitched against Mississippi College. The thing about Maynard, although I can joke about his last name, is he's only given up 4 runs, and that was only in one appearance. The rest of his appearances so far this year, he has not given up a single run, as his first pitch to Brock Butler is inside for a ball. Now, Maynard is not responsible for any of the batters that are up right now. Caleb Mahan is at third base as Butler swings and fouls one down the third baseline. I want to say that Mahan goes to Navarro. Carter and Vialta are to another one. And Brock Butler hits another line drive down the third baseline. Foul once again is behind in the count 1-2. And so McGinnis is responsible for Carter and Vialta. It's confusing, okay? That's all I'm saying. It's confusing because this is our third pitcher in the inning, and the bases are loaded, and two of the three are there's multiple pitchers that are still on their have their days going because of what's going on in this inning. As Butler takes another ball, this one outside, and the count is even at two apiece. There's only one out in the inning. UAH has the bases loaded. They've already plated one. And Maynard almost takes Brock Butler's kneecap off with a ball inside to make the count full. Vialta was hit. Merrick Carter was hit. And Brock Butler hits one to the shortstop. Schroeder grabs it, throws it to second. Second over to one. That's going to result in a double play. No more runs plate, but UAH adds one to it. So now we head to the top of the ninth inning. UAH holds a two-run lead as they try to wrap up game one of this three-game series. You are listening to Charger Baseball, 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
So Corey Haygood comes in looking for his seventh save of the season as he wrapped up the top of the eighth inning after throwing 13 pitches, and now he goes for another full inning of work here. His last save of the season came all the way back in February, as then on the 24th, he got a save against Truman. And he has not gotten a save since. He got a win last weekend in West Georgia. And now he is three outs away from his seventh save of the year. But to do so, he's going to have to face 2-3-4 from Shorter, as it's going to be Kobe Jones, Alex Brody, and Justin Barnes. At the least, as Kobe Jones steps in, 1-for-3 on the day. He's flied out twice. He's grounded out. He has also walked in the lefty down in his crouched open stance. Hits a hard ground ball to second as Vialta catches it and throws it over to first. One away off of one pitch. It was not pretty. I say it's not pretty because Vialta turned his head when trying to catch the ground ball. And I can't, I've been hit in the mouth before, I understand. I've gotten it, I've had it happen. Matter of fact, the last few years that I even played the infield position, I actually did so with a mouth guard. So, look, I understand how hard it can be sometimes to catch hard ground balls like Vialta did. But it wasn't a pretty one, but he made the out. As Alex Brody steps in, he's 1-for-3 on the day. He's already taken one pitch for a ball from the lefty, and the righty is currently 1-for-3 with a single, a strikeout. He has flown out, and now he swings at the second pitch, and he's looking at an even count of one apiece. Brody has 9 home runs right now. If he gets number 10, it only would make it a one-run game. Haygood's 1-1 pitch is going to be a called strike on the outside corner. Brody doesn't agree, but we don't have robo-ump, so he can't challenge it, which I'm a total fan of, but we're in the ninth inning, and that's not a topic to have at this point in time. Haygood steps off the hill, and now is back on the rubber, and the lefty is ready with the 1-2. and swung on and missed, and Alex Brody with his second strikeout of the day, and UAH is now one out away from taking game one of this three-game series, a monster three-game series for the Chargers season. And the righty, Justin Barnes, will step in after going 0-for-2 so far on the day. He has also walked twice. The one time he has gotten on base was a result of a Merrick Carter error. But Haygood has two outs, and the lefty delivers. As that's going to be a called strike on the outside corner. Haygood getting a lot of love on that right side corner right now. That's probably the third pitch that he has gotten called a strike so far during this appearance by him. Second called strike, this time on the inside portion of the plate. And Shorter is down to their last strike of the ball game. Corey Haygood, one pitch away from his seventh save of the season. And he gets it as Justin Barnes swings and misses, and UAH has picked up a monster Gulf South Conference win here at Charger Park to start this three-game series. When we come back post-game, as your UAH Chargers take the 4-2 win today here at Charger Park and are looking for the series win tomorrow afternoon. You have been listening to UAH Baseball. Next up is our post-game show on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage